tonight as we deal with the fallout from SummerMania 18 and the reformation of EBW. What does the spin of the wheel have in store for our roster? Jay Ellis and James Cerebral will go head-to-head once more tonight in a match to be determined by the spin of a wheel. What match type will Jay Ellis get a chance to shut James Cerebral down in? After Jesse Justice's walkout during the Tag Team Championship match at SummerMania 18, JJ Kelty demands answers. Find out if he gets them tonight. ACT and Corey Lee will be running back what was supposed to be a one-on-one encounter at SummerMania. However, the wheel holds the key as to what type of match they will be facing off in. Finally, we will hear from the new XCW champion Brady Branson after the shocking events of SummerMania 18, the return of Chris Jones, and the reformation of EBW with Hayden Bex. Will Moore join the faction? Will we see the XCW champion in action tonight? And who will step up to thwart the company that nearly closed the door on XCW 10 years ago? The answers to these questions and more as the 20th anniversary of XCW presents High Stakes 2023.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome, welcome, welcome to the XCW Galaxy, XCW High Stakes. Here we are, EBW Now introducing to the ring, the man who saved SummerMania 18, an original EBW member, Chris Jones.
I'ma worry about me, give a fuck about you, nigga. Just as a reminder to myself, I wear every single chain, even when I'm in the house. Cause we started from the bottom, now we're here.
Ladies and gentlemen, after making a surprise return to SummerMania 18 and dishing out super kicks and bringing back EBW, we finally get to hear what it all means. We don't like to do too much. Welcome back, Chris Jones. Story stay
the same, I never changed it. I like you sitting over there, that's where you deserve it. Nigga, we don't feel that. Fuck a fake friend, where your real friends at? We don't like to do too much explaining. Story stay the same, through the money and the fame. Cause we're standing on the floor, now started from the bottom, now my whole team fucking here. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team here. Nigga, started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team.
People should be showing him some respect.
Why don't you
This is the same crowd of people that cheered when I put my body on the line in that death match against Brogan. I took a freaking weed eater. And these people cheered for me. Now they boo me. This is the same crowd of people that Halloween Harvest first ever Full Metal Madness match. I went one-on-one with the monster Venom. And with my career on the line, my best friend of over 20 years career on the line, Fletch, Hazard, Kurt Acid. I walked out tall, but when Chris Jones' career's on the line, and I'm not the one in the ring, after Fletch promised me, after Emily Moore banned me from ringside, Fletch promised me. Do you know what he said to me, Brady?
What did he say?
He said, I have your back. And what happened? Fletch is a veteran. Over 20 years of experience. one of the first two XCW Hall of Famers. Do you know what happened, Hayden Vex?
Tell us, Chris.
He was outsmarted by Jackson Law. If Jackson Law came out to attack me and his career was on the line, I'd have super kicked those dick suckers off his face. So much for shaking up that pen so you could write a little bit more in that storybook, huh, Fletch? Chris Jones is here for one reason. Show that to the audience, Brady Branson. That is a symbol of excellence.
The original.
Disgusting.
5-2-23. For all of you people that might not understand codes and symbolism, 5-2-23 stands for EBW. And on this day, nearly 10 years ago, EBW was originally formed thanks to Gabe, who's no longer with us. But there's somebody that's also another part of the brains behind this project. Venom's not as smart as he might think he is. So I'm going to introduce to the person that helped make EBW possible once again, my friend, Luke Blaze!
Blaze Entertainment. Luke Blaze is, I mean, he's looking fresh, I'll give him that. That is a good look.
I'm gonna walk the money out of sell out.
Why is that Blaze?
Before I turn the microphone over to my new business partner, I want to do something. I know we talked about this, so I'm going to do this real quick, and then I'll turn the microphone over to you. Not only is Luke Blaze the new backer for EBW, I'm going to present something to your guys' EBW XCW champion, Breakaway Brady Branson.
For us.
To a true champion, my friend.
Boo! You suck, Brady!
A true champion indeed. True champion indeed. Now give it up for Breakaway Brady Branson, alright? Come on, one more time.
Even your best is still EBW.
You still suck.
And like Chris already said, you know, my business partner here, that 10 years ago, the copyright to EBW was formed, and somebody with the biggest pockets in this business decided to pick that up. And that's all thanks to Mr. Franchise Player, Chris Jones. So, and I mean, obviously, Venom's too stupid to realize that it was coming up, because obviously the general manager of XCW would have gotten informed that such a trademark was getting purchased. I guess he didn't check his email.
Not only that, something else we talked about. Originally, 10 years ago when EBW was formed, with myself, Gabe, and the invading James Cerebral, it was extreme backyard wrestling. Recently, a few years back, XCW, you know, didn't want to be outshined by the former EBW, so XCW changed their name to Explosive Championship Wrestling. So, me and Luke Blaze
had the idea, we're going to top XCW once again. We're changing EBW's name. It is no longer Extreme Backyard Wrestling. There is only one word to define what the new formation of this EBW group is, and that is Elite. And we are Elite Backyard Wrestling.
Tasteless. But, you know, all the breadcrumbs were there for you all to follow. I mean, did you guys not see the promo? 5223 EEW. I mean, I know we're in Shelbyville, but...
They must not follow me on Facebook.
That's right. Or myself, for that matter. But, you know, I mean, we are in Shelbyville, so I wouldn't expect you to know what a numerical alphabet was in the first place. But, you know, 5223 EBW. Accept Your Fate? That was on there. Hell, even my own name was on there, and you idiots couldn't figure it out. But I digress. You know, this collection of talent here is greater than anything that XCW's ever witnessed before. That's why we are Elite Backyard Wrestling. And basically, you're either with us or you're against us, to be quite honest. But we'll get on to bigger and better things, because if EBW is back, then I think something else should also come back. The EBW World Championship, perhaps. And I know not a lot of people are smart enough to know the history and all that, but the last EBW champion, I believe, if memory serves, it's this guy right here.
It was
Chris
me.
Jones.
No. It was me.
So I think we should have a match for that tonight. And I know Venom's not going to do anything to stop me. So why don't we just make that the main event tonight?
I have something.
Absolutely.
Not only that.
I love Coke bags all day.
How about, you know, we need to explain something first off, is I'm not on the XCW roster. I don't abide by the same rules each and every one of you abide by. I am above the law. So I will pick my own opponent tonight. And there's a competitor I have in mind. This is somebody that has held singles XCW gold. You both have held singles gold, correct? World champion, obviously. This person is a former XCW Tag Team Champion. I'm talking about defending my XCW Championship against the biggest superstar outside Brady and Hayden. On the XCW roster, there's no one else I'm sharing this ring with other than Miato Diaz! And the EBW Championship will be on the line, because EBW is all about opportunities. And the one thing XCW has never given Miato Diaz, the biggest superstar, is an what do you guys got? An opportunity. Oh, my God. You shouldn't have.
Of course.
This looks absolutely beautiful. So I appreciate you purchasing this out of your own pocket, Luke Blaze, because it doesn't look anywhere better than on my shoulder. EBW is here for two reasons. One, to run XCW into the ground once and for all. And Chris Jones does have an agenda. Chris Jones has four targets.
Whoa. Oh, now wait a minute.
That wasn't on my target list, Luke Blaze.
You must have some words for Luke Blaze. What is this mean to Onyx? I love closer, 'cause I'm just a fucking eye.
What can I do for you?
I don't know. I just
the hell
more
you
or
want?
Less care for an explanation for all this.
He just gave it to you.
Yeah, I mean, between me and Chris, we pretty much summed it all up.
You're not one of my targets, though, so.
I'm talking about us. Blaze Entertainment.
We can hear you.
So,
we can hear you. We can.
We're okay with that.
I just want to know, was it all a ploy with me and Phoenix, us turning on that man right there, me turning on Phoenix, having you talk in my ear for it?
What was everything since the 5-on-5 Allegiance match, the setup, was it all part of the plan?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, actually it was. I mean, you were kind of just a placeholder, if you will. You know, my second guy on the way to my third guy winning the Money in the Bank, you know, in the same year. It's never really been done before, so. But, I mean, you know, I know you haven't really talked to me since Summer Mania and all that. And I don't really blame you for that. But, you know, we can let bygones be bygones. I mean, look at your meteoric rise since you sat underneath my learning tree. Tag team championships, Money in the Banks, main events. Hell, you even got a Summer Mania moment because of Luke Blaze. So, you know, we won't offer you straight away, but, you know, maybe tonight you prove yourself, prove that you belong with this elite group of talent.
No. I like that idea. Prove himself. Prove himself.
And you know, it did take a while to get you that Blaze Entertainment t-shirt, so, you know, this time, we got one right up front.
Boo! No! No!
What's Alex gonna do?
No! No! No!
He has a choice to make. Could Luke Blaze turn on him again?
No!
Oh, come on, you never listened to him before, you know? Always do what you always do and listen to Luke Blaze.
You know? It is an interesting offer.
It is. It's an offer of a lifetime.
It's a fair offer. The greatest offer you can ever get.
Belts and big titty bitches.
But why would I team with a liar?
Yeah.
A man who didn't have a Summer Mania match until he stole that opportunity.
Ooh.
A man that lost to Blackheart at the biggest show.
Whoa.
And the man I got fired.
Technically, Jackson Law got me fired, but okay.
No offense, Blaze. I don't believe a word you say.
Yeah!
Uh-oh.
Don't listen to these stupid people.
In fact, if there's any company I would want to represent, it's the family business, XCW.
Yeah!
That's a good
XCW! XCW! XCW!
Well, can't say that was the smartest decision that you ever made.
Oh!
Together, boys.
Get it right.
I think this is going to serve as a lesson for anyone wanting to
what we're
not
about.
Accept EBW's offer.
Choke the shit out of him! Oh, but here's Flash coming in! Coming in to see the audience, that's what I'm talking about.
Helping the family business.
When he talks about family business, he's not just talking about XCW. He's actually my blood.
Yeah!
Yeah!
Woo!
And if you guys have an issue with him choosing the family business, it's not going to be like last time, Chris. You stupid bitch. I am going to make sure that my baby stays right where the fuck it's supposed to be. And I will make sure that I roll in to EBW City and burn that bitch to the ground.
Yeah!
I didn't build an empire for 20 years for assholes like you to come in here and try to take over. You want bleed something, huh? Swallow some.
Oh!
And Hayden, you're already halfway there.
Oh, shit.
So if you motherfuckers want to fight tonight, how about both of you step in the ring with me and Onyx, and we'll show you a family ass kicking.
Yeah!
Yeah!
I think they should do it.
They don't stand a chance!
Flesh coming out just saying Onyx is because of his blood. I think EBW definitely picked the wrong person to mess with, and now I think we may have a nice little tag team match, ladies and gentlemen, there tonight.
Come on!
Well, 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 you'll notice a new face on the table here, ladies and gentlemen. Steve-O, he has a little different role in the company now, and here is Eric Blackheart. Eric, that's weird to say now. Eric.
Is it?
Yeah,
is
but
it
I
weird to say?
But I like it. Welcome, officially,
thank you so much,
to the XCW commentary team.
I am super stoked to be here on the table now with you, calling the absolutely tremendous action of XCW every single show, and I cannot wait because I love high stakes. You know, a spin of the wheel can seal the deal, right?
100%. High stakes, one of the best shows of the year for that reason alone. You never know what's going to happen. The wheel.
You never know.
The wheel, it can make some insane mass stipulations. I guarantee we'll see
I've
some
just
tonight.
Been told. We actually have a spin of the wheel coming up right now. Jay Ellis is about to spin the wheel, so let's cut to that.
So I got this money making move for you.
Okay.
Out in Hong Kong, they're looking for a good Godzilla.
Okay.
And you know, you being the monster that you used to be, would be the perfect Godzilla. That's money for both of us. You know, I'd be your agent, put money in my pocket.
So, I got another idea too. Why don't I just be the next Stay Puft for Ghostbusters, and you can be one of the guys.
I could be.
You can be a Ghostbuster. Welcome in.
You got something to say?
Yeah.
You kind of interrupting something here.
Me and you. One more time.
You don't.
I know I could beat you. And you know it too.
You must obviously not get tired of me whooping that ass all the time. But see, let me tell you something though. You only came in here because I feel like you have something to try to prove, because your EBW brothers haven't even thought about you yet. They haven't came back here to say hi, what's up, even asked you to come out with them at any time. What's up with that? At least before me and my brother split up, he knew what being a brother actually was.
Well, let's do it one more time. What do you say?
Okay, whoa, let me. Sorry, I still had my brain on the whole Stay Puft thing. You know what? Because I'm the nice guy around here. I'll make it official. One more time. And I'm telling you, one more time, I will let it go down.
So you want me to beat him up once again?
Yeah, if that's what happens, that's what happens. If he wins, he wins. I will let one more chance happen. But first, I need you to spin the wheel.
Gladly.
Ooh, Clockwork House of Fun match.
Means I get to hit you with shit.
Oh, more stuff for me to whip that ass with too, huh?
Alright, I'll see you later. One more time.
Hey, remember what I said about that EBW.
I'll see you later, bro.
Son of a bitch!
Where is he? 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 What the fuck?
Hey! Stop! Where's Chris Jones? Where is he? Is he in the house?
I have no
Where
idea.
Where is Chris?
This crazy needs to stop. Go find him yourself.
You insanity can't fucking give me basic directions!
fucking weird people.
The following match is a Clockwork House of Fun match. Introducing first. Of 222 pounds. He hails from St. Augustine, Florida. Jay Elvis!
The weapons are already at ringside, JJ. This is going to be a belter.
Sir Blackheart, and you know.
Blackheart, is it Eric?
Yeah, just call me Eric. Eric Blackheart.
All right.
Hey! What's up?
Hey, Elvis.
You liking it already?
I don't have to beat myself up.
Are they paying you?
Wait, what?
They didn't get to know? You didn't get the memo?
No.
Oh.
You
know
what?
No, I know.
I did. Contract negotiations.
Yeah, that, you know, stuff happens. It's okay.
The spin of the wheel, obviously, as you said, Eric, landing on Clockwork House of Fun, a hardcore match with weapons strung up. Oh, man, a hellacious one to be sure.
Pinfall submissions, no DQ, no count out. Weapons are not only legal but encouraged. These two are going to run it back.
And introducing his opponent.
Summer Mania rematch, you might say.
Sir, there's a match and a half of there as well.
His way to the ring. Coming in at a weight of 180 pounds, he hails from Brooklyn, New York, and is an EBW original. The Untamable Cerebro!
Cerebro would rep in them colors all year. You had to wonder if he's been in on it the whole time, JJ.
100%. They are the only ones, you know. No fresh orange duds like everyone else, but you have to think he was, like you said, an original member.
He is an OG, so I guess OG colors, right?
I'm sure he'll get a roster invite here soon enough. I'm sure they don't want to forget about a legacy member.
True enough.
Rainbow! Our first match together. This is going to be nice. I'm excited. Good to have you on the
table. This is a good first match to start.
Yes, sir.
Hardcore as hardcore can get. Weapons at ringside.
And the first spin of the wheel, a Clockwork House of Fun. Whew. Good for Jay Ellis starting it off right here. Colorful title.
Gonna back him into the corner here.
Both men pretty evenly matched in the strength department. Oh! Nice.
Give him another!
Oh! Jay's paintbrushing him now.
Oh. Serving him up like dinner.
Finger licking good.
Half plates for everybody!
Yes, sir.
Yeah, oh my god. Cerebral already in there, attacking in the corner.
So that was Jay Ellis' mindset, Summer Mania. Oh
my god, just tossed him by his dreads.
Leave the dreads alone.
Disrespect. Look at the disrespect.
Tosses. I'm sure we'll see plenty more to be before this match is over, Black.
DDT spikes him on the head.
Right in the
canvas. Cerebral gonna go for that leg drop. That Brooklyn leg drop. There it is.
Man. James Cerebral.
No.
How's that dictate?
Gross. I can tell you from experience, they honor each other.
It's a particularly hot day out here. I'm sure it's even worse.
I've been cooking.
Oh man, James Cerebral taking it back.
Oh my god, backs him in the
forearm to the face.
As you said, anything goes.
True. The ref's only there to count the pinfall and submission, nothing else. Look at this beautiful suplex by Jay Ellis, takes him over cover. Nope, Cerebral got a shoulder up.
Try to end things early. Can't blame him there. James Cerebral, not an opponent you want to underestimate and let the match go too long on.
Got him in a almost chicken wing here kind of maneuver. Sort of like a million-dollar dream, sort of like a chicken wing maneuver.
About to say, looks effective here, James Cerebral.
I mean, if you got it cinched in enough, it'll cut off the circulation to your head. You will be able to breathe. Cerebral couldn't breathe there for a minute. He got a break, but...
Jay Ellis known for those choke holds. He can put a man out real quick.
And here's the thing about the clockwork match is that he can be outside for as long as he wants. There's no countouts. He can take as long as he needs to out there. He's already walking around the ring. Hopefully we'll see some weapons here real soon.
Looks like...
Oh, he grabbed! He grabbed the scissors!
The item used to cut the props down.
The only thing it's cutting right now is Jay Ellis.
Oh, man.
Cut the hair!
What's he gonna get?
Unfortunately legal.
100%.
Oh, man, he's got that baking sheet.
Yes, sir. He's got street signs, crutches. Oh!
My God!
He's making more than cookies today.
I literally took one of them to the head 2 weeks ago. That does not feel good, I can tell you.
About to say.
Oh, my goodness!
Leonardo Diaz!
Yeah! That's all you got, boy!
Yeah! Oh! Guillotines him with the baking sheet.
Jay Ellis.
Oh, God!
Did you hear that?
There was some velocity on that one.
Man.
My goodness.
Definitely some bad blood spilling over from SummerMania 18. Oh, man.
No doubt about it. Jay Ellis is in a bad way right now, JJ.
Unfortunately, each
competitor. Look out.
There we go. DDT from Jay Ellis.
Nice receipt for the DDT earlier. And now Ellis in control with the baking sheet across the back. He's bent it. Oh my God, look at that baking sheet. Oh my God. That was a fresh baking sheet before they used it.
100%. I know those aren't titanium, Eric, but Jesus.
They're still, that's metal and metal hurts.
Exactly.
Jay Ellis is stepping over top of James Cerebral here. My God.
Not the last disrespect we'd see is James Cerebral. Oh!
Trying to lariat him over the top. Oh my goodness, almost had him there.
Jay Ellis contorted.
Jay going to the outside. You're not safe out there, my God!
Advantage.
Springboard dive tope over the top rope onto Jay Ellis. Both men outside. Again, no countouts. They can be out there as long as they want.
North Festus keeping a good eye on both competitors, and they're back on their feet here. And it has to wonder what's next.
Steel ring post for Jay Ellis.
Well, that's what's next.
That is what's next. You're right.
Oh, he's taking him around.
Taking him for a tour of the islands here. Crowd firmly behind Jay Ellis here. He's got to try to get some momentum. Oh, wait a minute. Oh! As I said that, James Cerebral was laid out in front of us here.
And that's how it goes, Eric. That's how
what is Ellis doing? Oh, my God. No. Oh, my God!
Taking flight.
Suicide dive by Jay Ellis.
Taking flight, and he hit every bit of that. Oh, man.
Can Jay Ellis capitalize?
This could
here
be
comes
it.
The pin, right here. Here's the cover. Referee in position. No, two count only. Wow. How is Cerebral kicking out after all the punishment he's taken?
Another close count, Eric. But I will say that was a little closer than last time. Jay Ellis is getting there.
Fuck him up, Ellis. Fuck him up.
I see a big fan of Jay Ellis.
Yes, they are, as they should be. What is Ellis going for now?
Maybe a weapon of his. He's going on the irony board.
Oh, the irony.
Oh, I see what you did there.
Yeah. That was cute.
Thanks. Thanks, Mom.
There we go. Uh-oh, James Cerebral.
It looks flimsy, but it's not, I assure you. That will hurt. That stings like a muh.
Let's see if he can get it set up and put James Cerebral through it.
Oh, God, that's not going to feel good.
Not at all.
Not the suplex. My goodness, no. They flatten that iron. And now the sleeper hold. Could transition into the Kahuna Clutch if he can get position.
That might be it for James Cerebral if he can't make something happen.
Cerebral getting to his feet though. way of breaking it.
Got the already quarter of the now. Whoa!
I cannot wait to see what the rest of this show holds. We got more right after this.
Jesse. What the hell? You walked out on me halfway through the match of SummerMania for the tag team titles. And then you ignore my calls, my texts. I even went to your house. Have you been avoiding me for some fucked up reason?
Yeah.
Don't get me wrong, we had a hell of a run. But that crazy shit is not for me.
That not crazy even, shit is us.
It was you guys.
What are you talking about, you guys? Herbert not with you no more? Like, what the hell's going on?
It's a new leaf, a new justice. But don't get me wrong. We held it down pretty fucking well.
You seen what I did to my brother, right? 2 years ago, when I gave him his final lesson not to trust anybody? We had something good. I'm not letting this tag team go. If you want to win this and it be done, then you're doing a match with me tonight. You win, I'll accept it.
But I said I'm done. But if you want one more, let bygones be bygones. After this one last, we're done.
Only if you win.
Only if we'll,
I'll see you after. I win. We stay a team.
I'm sorry. Win or lose, this is done.
You sure this is what you want?
This is what I've always wanted. It's quiet in here now. Finally, me.
Oh. Looks like I gotta go get ready.
Son of a bitch! What am I doing? Nobody fucking be in there! Hello? Where's that piece of shit? Are you in here? I saw you eat fucking. You! Where the fuck is he? Where's Chris Jones?
I don't know!
Where is he at?
I don't know!
This is bullshit! Fuck!
Jeez, I'm just trying to do a match!
Interesting. I did not expect it to go like that.
I think we've seen the last of the Cold Hearted Crazies as a tag team. They're going to meet later tonight, as it turns out, one-on-one action.
I wonder if they can put this bad blood to rest, but...
Well, I guess we're going to have to wait and find out. And speaking of bad blood, Brogan is so upset.
Can you blame him, though?
I can't blame him. If I retired Chris Jones and he came out of retirement, I'd be upset, too. I would be upset, too. I'm just saying. So I feel for Brogan O'Shea in that instance, in that regard.
Because, I mean, really, all it's a text, a call. You know, I'm sure he's still got his number, you know.
Right?
Take 2 seconds. But whatever. We'll just have to see if he can find him.
Okay, what is this?
Wait a minute. That wasn't on the agenda for tonight.
Yeah, I don't have this on the format. What's going on? Does this always happen here?
No, but I recognize the music, ladies and gentlemen. That is the essential one.
Oh.
Rob Slater. And... Hot off the heels of SummerMania 18? It's good to see you back, though, at XCW Alum, a long time ago, and now he's back. You love to see it. Thanks to, I guess, Justin Parsley.
Looks like he's got a microphone, so I guess we're gonna let him have the floor.
You know, ever since Extreme King, when Fletch offered me an opportunity to come back to XCW, I took it. I took it because I had one thing in mind. That one thing was history. History that has not been resolved yet. That history involves Justin Parsley. A lot of people have been asking me, am I back? To team with Justin? Or finally get him in this ring one-on-one? You see, we've had a lot of history together. We've been on the same side. We've been on opposite sides of this ring. And yet, I have to make a decision. Well, you guys want a decision? Am I with Justin or against Justin? Well, all right. I guess my answer is
another interruption here.
Oh my God, that's Unholy's music.
Yes, sir.
What in the world do they want now? DJ Walbert and Shane Shaw, the XCW Tag Team Champions.
Say to them, he's not in the Tag Team Division unless maybe the Seminole Warrior? That would mean he's probably with Justin Parsley. I want to hear the answer.
Me too. I'm intrigued, to say the least.
Well, I guess we'll see what Unholy has to say out here. What they want with Rob Slater, especially if they're, like you said, winning the tag team championships.
Oh, Robbie. You know, you're speaking of Justin.
What?
I get that, okay? Shut your fucking mouth, okay? If I could hang you all, I fucking would, and that's a fucking shoot. Well, you know, Justin, we're not done yet. You know, I showed him evil. He brought out a tiny bit of evil, but there's a lot more to show than that. You know, the reason why I kidnapped Amanda is because I was trying to get to Justin. And well, I did. And you know, in fact, Robbie, I have to say one thing.
Not Robbie, Robbie.
Oh. Robbie, yes, Robbie.
What? Can't hear you.
Who's Robbie? Robbie, they call it
DJ. So you know, I have a solution, okay?
Do ya?
What do you say, okay? You join the evil. What is your answer, okay? We really want to know. Unholy really wants to know. That's a way of life. You join Unholy, or else.
Boo!
What is your answer, huh? What is your answer, Robbie? You tell me, buddy. You tell me.
That's not the question I thought him to ask.
You tell me.
What does the history with you and Justin have to do with me?
There's a lot that has to do with it. There's a lot that has to do with that. You know, in fact, in fact, you know, you and Justin have a thing, right? You know that you have history. I don't know if he was your boyfriend at one point or not. I don't know. But in fact, there's a major issue. So answer my question, or else.
Answer my damn question. Now. Now.
Or else what?
Go right ahead. Go right ahead.
No!
Do it!
Do you know who you're standing in the ring with?
Yes, I do, and you know, you're irrelevant to me.
I don't follow orders.
You're just some other useless fuck that comes here just like all these people. Just like all these people. Who all look like half meth heads.
You want an answer?
Who I'd knock any of their fucking teeth out? Try me?
What's DJ so mean? He hates the galaxy. No.
Again.
Oh,
is that so? Is that so?
He said no.
Ha ha. Ah! He's got taste!
So Shane.
He knows better.
Do it.
Uh-oh, wait a minute. See ya.
Dumps Rob Slater on his head. Oh no.
Jesus. Well, I kind of unfortunately figured this was gonna happen. We're gonna beat the hell out of it.
Wolbert's going for the coffin drop. Yeah, come on.
Putting the nail in the coffin.
There is no reason for this.
He's getting him set up. Oh god.
Oh my god!
Come on!
Right on his chest. This is despicable.
Oh, just because he didn't want to join Unholy?
I told you.
My god, somebody please put a stop to this.
Talking about, somebody save the Ascension.
They tied him
Slater.
In the ropes? What?
They're holding him up. Jesus.
Yeah, you gotta tie up a guy because we can't.
I don't even want to know what they're setting him up for here. It's gonna leave him
out. It can
out
only
here.
Be bad.
There
I can tell you that.
There it is. There it is. Unholy for life. There is no such thing as a god. There is no such thing as a god.
Unholy. Probably not making a statement, Eric.
Yeah, the statement is you're not with us, you're against us, clearly. Rob Slater just found that out.
Leave him. Hopefully
somebody's got to help him. He's tied to the ropes. Can we get a help out here for Rob Slater, please? Somebody get these clowns out of here.
There they go, and Rob Slater left to die out here in the beating sun.
We need to get somebody out here to untie Rob from the ropes, please. Anyway, can we cut to something else? Cut to something else.
So what's up?
Man, I know since I was here last time I was drunk, and now that I've been back, I just don't know how I feel, and it seems like drinking would be better, and help better with the shows and my matches, maybe win more. I mean, I just don't know what to do.
I'll tell you what. Well, sounds like, you need to start drinking again.
What the fuck did you just say?
Yeah, you need to start drinking again.
I think you lost your goddamn mind.
Now look, we're friends here, right? I like to think you're my friend, right?
No.
We can make a real good team here. Look,
you've lost your mind.
I tell you what.
No.
Listen, we'll have a match tonight. And if you win, I'll buy you a pint.
No. I'll still have the match with you, but no.
Look, the first 17 rounds are free on me. XCW paid right here from my couch. 17 no. shots. You want to make it 18 to make it an even number?
No.
Well, goddamn. No, look, we're still going to do this match, and I'm still going to take you out for a drink because fuck it. Okay?
If I even get up, no. I'm not getting into another drink. No. You're a terrible therapist.
Oh, I've had a dollar for every time I've heard that.
I feel like you mean, who's your therapist, Venom?
To a point.
Well, there it goes, right there.
I mean, he was my best friend.
Well, why don't you guys go have a drink then?
Because he's not my best friend, you are.
No.
Yes.
You're tripping more than me right now.
No, possible. I'm sober.
And so am I.
Well, goddamn! Hey, let's change that!
The following match is scheduled for one fall.
Let's look at me for a second, man. I was leaving the pressure, making me weak and pathetic. I thought I needed that pressure to leave the pressure. I'm feeling the infection, repeating the lessons, but only lead to me, and that's a lethal injection. And I was chasing the dragon with no man evil.
Making his way to the ring. Coming in at a weight of 176 pounds, he hails from Cameron, North Carolina, Cold Hearted JJ Kelsey.
Well, the Cold Hearted Crazies are no more. They're about to go one-on-one here.
Surprising, I didn't think they'd implode that quickly and they saw cracks, but
I don't know. Jesse hasn't been the same since you took that headshot a couple months ago at the hands of the Unholy.
You're telling me.
And introducing his opponent.
And I think JJ noticed too.
Making his way to the ring. Coming in at a weight of 250 pounds. He hails from Mesa, Arizona. Jesse Justice.
I don't think he's so frantic anymore. He's just normal Jesse Justice at this point, isn't he?
We called him frantic. He got very mad. He was not happy about that.
Yeah, I don't... he's not frantic. He's normal Jesse Justice.
Yes. And as you'll notice, Ref Steve-O in his new official
yes,
capacity.
Yes, he is. That's where he went, if you were wondering where he went.
I told you to see him, and here he is, his first match.
I'm tired of the weird
Free Steve.
All around.
Jesse said he's tired of the weirdness.
Kick his ass, Jesse.
He's ass, see bass.
All right.
I know you heard it. Jesse said he's done.
Yep. Ring the bell. Let's get it on.
Oh. And Kelty starting already with the forearms. Knocking Jesse Justice into the corner.
Get out of there.
Something's not in so well at SummerMania 18. Getting abandoned, losing the gold.
Oh!
Right to the
big Superman punch there.
Face!
And another, my God!
Christ almighty, Jesse Justice! You might be done already!
Is JJ trying to re-scramble his brains?
You're telling
That's what
me!
I'm trying to figure out your cover. Two. Count says our referee, Steve.
He says it's going to take more than that to take him down. But like you said, with the hits to the head over and over, Eric.
I think JJ Kelty is trying to re-scramble his brain so he'd become frantic again.
I mean, maybe they could become a tag team again. You never know. If that's what JJ Kelty wants.
Oh! And the knees right to the side of the head, too. The proof is in the pudding, JJ.
It's just not stopping. It's definitely the game plan is becoming clear, Eric. For sure, for sure.
I think you can even see it in his face. He wants the old Jesse Justice back. He wants the team back together.
He wants some gold, too. That would be nice to go along with it.
But as long as Jesse's acting the way he's acting, it's just not going to happen, JJ.
That's definitely a different
he's
Jesse.
He's not here anymore.
He's not here anymore. You heard it. There it is.
I miss her.
As do I. JJ Kelty taking that as a challenge.
Enziguri.
Yes, sir.
Taking down Jesse Justice.
Big hang time on that one. And Jesse Justice going to have to make something happen. Or...
Oh, springboard leg drop.
Yes, sir. Right on there. Effective.
Go, Jesse. Let's go.
I think Kelty might have hurt himself there in the process. Unable to capitalize on that leg drop.
Jesse not staying down. Oh! Yeah.
Ooh, uppercuts the back of the knee. Chopping down the cherry tree, as it were.
That's what I'm talking about, working on the leg. That's a smart maneuver
ring.
There.
And this is a... Let's go. Come on back in. One!
Standard match. Steve-O getting it.
Come on, buddy.
Control
I have never seen JJ Kelty look
Come
like this.
Buddy.
I have never seen him so upset as to lose his tag partner like this.
Not at all. Even when Violent Ending ended, that wasn't his...
And Jay Ellis is like a brother to him. And
exactly.
This is heartbreaking.
I think it was just maybe the suddenness
of
everything.
Come on, you can't do that. Come on. Grab him, come. Let him come
That's
out.
That's the thing. They were
Thank
working
you.
Well as a team. They were tag team champions.
Thank you.
And now look at them. feel a little, I gotta feel a little bit for JJ Kelty here.
That's something I never thought I would say.
Me either. What is Jessa doing? Oh my god, just kick that bottom rope up into the throat of JJ Kelty, my goodness.
I was wondering what he was doing there.
JJ Kelty's gotta find the muster to get back into this somehow, some way.
Yes, sir, because otherwise, oof, this really could be the end. They may never see the inside of a ring together. Oh, my Lord, that's a sad thing.
Big chop. Another. Jacob Black, that was a low blow right in front of the referee.
Come on.
Steve using his discretion here and letting it go, but can't do that a second time. He will call for the bell.
About to say he's gotta make something happen here, especially with another low blow.
Short attack was here by JJ in the corner.
Makes you wonder what's next in the tag team division now that the cold-hearted crazies are no longer in there.
Pele kick into the corner on Jesse Justice.
Look at that, getting some hang time. Unfortunately for Jesse Justice, that for break. Ref sees it.
Yep. Good eye there by our new referee, Steve-O.
Yes, sir. Oh, Jesse trying to choke the life out of him, getting a submission here. Interesting here.
I can't tell, but it's sort of a chicken wing-ish maneuver.
He does not give.
I think
he does not give.
He could have grabbed what he could and made the best of it. Hey, sometimes it works, but not that time. JJ Kelty able to break out of it. But what has Jesse Justice got in store for his ex-tag partner now?
I have no idea. I shudder to think. Some to the eye.
He's doing this. Come on now. No breaking out the eye. One more.
He's still a bad guy at heart. You can't fault that.
JJ Kelty getting warned, says, watch out. One more. You're out of here, bud.
He just looked deep in the face before delivering that punch. There's emotion behind these blows.
No doubt about it. A man felt betrayed. JJ Kelty, he's got one thing, it's loyalty.
That's right. You may not be a fan of his methods, but you got it. There's a piece of you that's got to feel for the guy in this season.
100%.
100%.
Especially.
Justice backs him into the corner.
It's like seeing two friends go toe-to-toe with one another. It's never good. But that's the way it goes sometimes.
Big chop coming up. Just shot right to the thigh, the inner thigh, the knee. He's been working that knee the whole match.
Definitely a more cerebral Jesse Justice. Thinking about
it. That's a different wrestler.
Yeah, right. Definitely using his noggin. A third Superman punch.
Kelty just popped up out of that from nowhere almost.
So you gotta watch out.
What's he gonna do here?
Went for the twist of fate!
He went for it!
But Jesse counters into the better stunner!
Oh my god, did you hear him say I'm sorry before he did that?
You were right!
Oh, the bonus!
And that could be it!
Two and three, it's over!
The winner of this match, as a result of a pinfall, Jesse Justice!
He said I'm sorry, JJ.
We see a new Jesse Justice. Maybe this is the new JJ Kelty.
JJ Kelty said he was sorry before he tried to deliver the finishing blow. I've never heard that from the man.
Not at all. It always seems personal.
And Justice lifting him up, helping him up to his feet.
What's he doing? Look at that. There we go.
That's good to see. You love to see it.
The sportsmanship.
As Kelty collapses back to the mat.
Quit asking, he's gone.
Yeah, Herbert's gone. Jesse Justice picking up the win here at high stakes, JJ.
We got another spin of the wheel coming up here.
Yes, we do. I'd say let's get right to it. More high stakes right after this.
What's up, big guy?
Hey, how are you doing? I'm doing great.
Dude,
awesome.
Great. See my Summer Mania match?
I did.
I put Hobbs through a flaming table.
Burn.
Dude. I put him through a table so bad, he ain't even here anymore.
I can tell.
See?
But I have something for you. I want you to go ahead and spin the wheel.
I get to spin the wheel?
You get to spin the wheel.
Bro, you know I always wanted to do this. Let's go. Let's go. Here we go. Big money. I mean, I guess I'm on the card, but I feel like I'm always in these matches, dude. Like, it's just, I can't escape them.
A four-way, a little tough.
How you doing, bud?
He's doing great. I just
Shut up. I'm not talking to you.
First off, not your bed. Second off.
Shut up.
Don't
shut
smack
up.
My back.
Shut up.
Okay.
Shut up. So what I want to know is, where's my spin of the wheel?
Well, you, bud, don't get to spin the wheel.
Well, bud, why do I get to spin the wheel, bud?
I'll tell you why.
No.
I'll tell you why.
Why does he get to spin the wheel?
I won my Summer Mania match. That's why. You didn't. I believe you got a KO. In front of the fans.
Speaking of Summer Mania, what do you think? You're some kind of superhero or something?
I mean, yeah, I am. Hold on. Clark Kent. Evan Phoenix. Do you believe it? You couldn't even tell me, did you?
Burn.
Look.
Unbelievable. Like, the science behind it, unimaginable.
This whole superhero stick, it actually gets on my nerves, because while I'm the law of the land, I'm the real hero in XCW. I make sure everybody abides by the laws, and you stand here and put on a black mask over your face and try to cover up that ugly mug and think that that's what a hero is.
He thinks he's a hero? You think you're a hero?
I'm a hero.
It doesn't matter what you think! Burn!
That's my
there
shit!
There we go! Burn! You're welcome.
Burn!
What? I want to spin the wheel.
You don't get to spin the wheel. Because you're in a fatal four with him.
Wait. You had me until that point.
That has got to be the smartest thing that's ever come out of that dumb-looking head of yours.
Okay. Is it because Tommy beat the stupid ideas out of yours?
Shut up. He's not here anymore. I'm in the Fatal 4-Way.
Yes.
I'm in the Fatal 4-Way.
I mean, that's whatever, man. I'm in the Fatal 4-Way, and you know what? I'm on the card.
There you go.
You want to know who isn't on the card? Hobbs.
Yeah.
Burn. Let's go.
Have a good day.
I'll see you. Yeah, you just do whatever you do.
Still should have let me spin the wheel, you jackass. Oh.
The following match is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring, 385 pounds. He hails from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, Julian Boyd Jacobs.
Julian Boyd Jacobs coming off of his loss to Eric Mason at Summer Mania for the New Age title. He's looking to get back into the winning column here. Speaking of the winning column, Evan Phoenix won his match at Summer Mania, and he's got a fatal four-way he spun for later tonight.
Lucky him.
And we already know that Jackson Wall is going to be a part of that. We already know Evan Phoenix is going to be part of that.
We'll have to see the other two competitors, XCW Galaxy. But that's going to be a stacked match for
that
sure.
I'm excited to find out who is the better man, the cop or the superhero.
To see Vigilante Justice.
And introducing his opponent. Making his way to the ring. Of 254 pounds, he hails from Seattle, Washington, Nick
another EBW guy. You gotta wonder if he's gonna be with the new regime or if he's strictly XCW this time around. Which I guess only time will tell, JJ.
I was about to say, I don't know if he'll be joining the EBW roster this time around.
You ready? Ring the bell!
Here we are, these two. Like you said, Julian Jacobs coming fresh off the summer loss here. Mitchell Maverick.
Wow. Definitely. Power of Julian Boyd Jacobs there.
100%. Both of these men probably. We'll see if they're evenly matched, I guess. A test of strength.
Nobody will that mean when it comes to Monday night.
Ooh. Kicked to the midsection. I was wondering if that was a good idea, and there's the proof. It really wasn't. God!
Yes, sir. Christ almighty. Big time. Getting up there. And Mitchell Maverick dropped to the canvas.
Jacobs in control in the early goings of this matchup.
Yes, sir. Julian.
Big right hand. Knocks Mitchell Maverick for a loop.
That's what you're saying. You gotta think. Mitchell Maverick's been in the ring very much as Julian Jacobs. So you gotta think he's probably gonna. Little rusty's gonna shake off.
Cover.
One, two.
And then.
Nope.
Two.
Maverick able to get a shoulder up, but both of these men, former New Age champions, by the way, I just wanted to point out. So there's some common ground here between these two.
Oh, I see you over there.
Here we go, into the corner, no off the ropes. Big meat hook coming up, there it is, meat hook clothesline.
Yes, sir, taking him down. No easy feat for Julian Jacobs.
Covered by Mitchell.
One, two.
No.
Close, I thought that was gonna be it.
I thought so too. Jacobs just able to get that shoulder up. Maverick smart, staying on him.
Definitely can't let him get a breath.
No, you can't let Julian Jacobs get back to his feet. That's where he's his most dangerous.
I'm saying, if you do, you gotta make sure you have a plan in mind to keep him in the corner, get in there real quick.
What's Maverick going for here? Oh, big shoulder block in the corner.
Yes, sir, right into it. Uh-oh.
Cover again.
One, two.
No! Oh my god, that was so close.
I have to say, I thought he was going to lose there. Julian Boyd Jacobs, he's got to turn it around here. Or that next cover might be his last.
Sleeper hold applied by Mitchell Maverick.
Oh, he's got locked in there.
Going to cut off that airflow, that circulation. Try to put Julian Jacobs to sleep.
Uh-oh.
It's not going to work, it looks like. It looks like he's getting back to his feet.
Sir, he didn't get the hold good enough. Oh, Julian Jacobs gonna make him pay for that.
Look out! Oh, big shoulder tackle by Boyd.
Yes.
Julian Boyd Jacobs now back in control of this match.
Yes, sir.
Oh my God. This could be that STF submission. He's got it locked in, but Mitchell Maverick a little too close to the ropes. Good ring awareness by the veteran.
Good for him. You don't see Julian Jacobs pull the submissions out often. Really put it on the line here.
Here we go. Vintage Void DDT there. Beautifully executed. Spikes Mitchell Maverick on his head. He could have him here. He's got him covered. He's covered.
Oh, ref going for the pinfall. Looking to see it here.
One,
see if we can end it.
Two.
No! My goodness, that was close.
And these two.
They might have both had an arm over their shoulders there.
Right? Hard to tell from this angle, Eric. But both of these men. Enjoying there.
Into the
first time in the ring.
Yep. Another shot in the corner there for Mitchell Maverick.
So he's really trying to keep him in there.
A little hip toss into the corner. Another cover.
Ooh, real break.
Jacobs now with the ring awareness.
Hey, he has been in the ring for quite a long time.
Where's Maverick going? That was a mistake.
He says no.
Uh-oh.
I'm taking him home.
That's going to be the end of that. Real quick. Boom!
See ya.
One, two, three.
And the FU seals the deal for Julian Boyd Jacobs.
The winner of this match, as a result of a pinfall, Julian Boyd Jacobs.
Hey. There you have it, avenging his SummerMania 18 loss to Eric Mason by taking down another former New Age champion in Mitchell Maverick.
And still great accomplishment there for Julian Jacobs and making it look easy. That FU at the end, picking him up. Like a little sportsmanship here.
You're seeing a lot of that tonight.
It's nice, especially with the EBW, you know, shadow looming ahead.
Julian Boy Jacobs, once again, your victor here at High Stakes. And ladies and gentlemen, don't go anywhere. We got more action headed your way.
Hey, how's it going?
How are you doing, buddy?
Oh, so, doing good.
Brought you in here. I want you to spin the wheel.
Okay. I gotcha.
Ooh, a fatal four-way.
Okay. Well, son of a bitch! Okay. Has anybody seen fucking Chris Jones? I've run around this goddamn house like a fucking monkey in a goddamn cage! Hey, you fat fuck and you fat fuck. Where's Chris Jones? Where is he?
I don't know.
What the fuck? I don't care about your little fucking wheel. I don't care about this stupid fucking company right now. What I care about is Chris Jones being back. And you son of a bitch! No! No! Fuck! Come on now! He's lucky as you two monkey fucks! Yeah, leave. Go ahead. Fucking leave. Like I'm not gonna come back.
Hey, 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 hey! Hold on. Before you go out that door, do you have the second fatal four-way happening today? So here's what we're gonna do.
Okay.
I'm gonna add you to fatal four-way also.
Who's all it has? Chris Jones and EBW.
Right? Unfortunately, it's not. But Eric Mason's in it also, and it is for the New Age title.
Look at me, right here, right? I want to have a connection when I tell you this. Who fucking cares? Are you stupid? EBW's running rampant, and you're asking me about a fucking four-way? Everybody right here, stupid! You stupid fox!
Four-ways are good.
It is. All right, I'll give him that old school ass whooping.
There you go.
Thank you, Venom.
Life's a death to me. It's like the air I breathe. wanted to say. Hey, Mr. GM, how's it going?
I'm doing great.
Really? I heard you got something in store for me tonight. Dude, you know, I just closed off the biggest chapter of my career in Brogan O'Shea. I'm honestly glad to have it over, so I'm ready to see what's next for the International Championship.
So, let's spin the wheel.
Let's do it!
Go up there.
Pink!
Come on.
Oh, mystery opponent. Well, I definitely have my work cut out for me.
It looks like you do, GM. Well, no matter what you do, just make sure that they're international championship worthy. All right? Do that.
Hey, buddy.
Thank you very much, sir.
Who am I going to pick? Well.
Okay.
Wow. Hunter. Mystery opponent?
Yeah.
I cannot wait to see who that's going to be. Hunter Halkin going to be facing a mystery opponent here tonight at High Stakes.
Kind of, that's going to get in your headspace. Kind of hard to prepare for a match if you don't know who your opponent is going
right,
to be.
Right. So I've learned earlier tonight, Eric Mason spun the wheel, also got a fatal four-way.
Another
just
one.
Like Evan Phoenix did, so they decided to put them together. So we now know
really?
That the fatal four-way, and it will be for the New Age title, it's going to be Eric Mason, okay. Brogan O'Shea,
okay.
Evan Phoenix.
Okay.
And whoever that fourth one was, I forgot.
Oh, Jesus. Who was the fourth one? Oh, man. It was, what's his face? Good old Jackson. What's his face?
Jackson Long.
The cop. Yeah, I was about to say.
How could you forget a face like that?
We had a great interview at SummerMania, you know. He's not
okay,
my friend's
listening. That's the greatest one way to describe it. Okay.
But, ladies and gentlemen, we got more action for you.
Yeah, that four-way. It's actually
right now.
Yeah, 10-minute time limit. Let's do it.
The following match is a fatal four-way, and it is for the XCW New Age Championship. Introducing the first challenger.
Bested Brandon Hardcore Hobbs just 2 weeks ago in that flaming tables match. It looks like his face is mostly healed up. That's good news to see.
Good to see Karma finally bit Brandon Hardcore Hobbs on the ass.
Yeah, he's tried to blind too many people with that fireball. I should know.
Two more than necessary, that's for damn sure.
That's absolutely correct.
And introducing the second challenger. Coming in at a weight of 320 pounds, he hails from Indianapolis, Indiana. He is the law of the land, Jackson Law!
I think he glared at me for
yeah,
forgetting
him. Yeah, I was going to say, that look said it all. I won't forget his name.
That's
anymore.
Fair, although considering the way he's acting. Losing to Tommy Merriman in that street fight 2 weeks ago at SummerMania 18 after he took a brutal kill switch in the stands, literally in front of the fans.
Yeah, what a finish that was.
That was.
Lighting. And here he stands 2 weeks later.
Yep. I gotta wonder if he's 100% after that street fight. I mean, they beat the hell out of each other.
Quite a bit.
And introducing the third challenger.
Oh, yeah.
like the way he slammed his jacket down on our table, does JJ?
Hey!
Aggressively
through his you glasses. See these colors?
Yeah.
This is my fucking ring! I'll put my shit where I want to!
Fair enough. Fair enough.
Well, most of it's been in his mouth, so I understand that.
And introducing that, your XCW New Age Champion! Making his way to the ring, coming in at 310 pounds, he hails from Huntsville, Alabama, Eric Mason!
Eric Mason's got to be getting close to being able to cash in that New Age Championship on the international champion, who at current time is Hunter Halkin, as we know.
100% that Lucky 7 rule, yes sir.
Eric Mason has been very dominant since debuting here in XCW. He's run through a lot of names, yours truly included.
Yes sir, I've seen it. I commentated it.
Yeah, I was there for it, I think.
You brought for me to remember.
Why am I competing for a new guy belt? I'm just saying.
Brogan is not happy he's here, but I think he should be happy with the opportunity.
I take umbrage with new guy belt. That's the only belt I've never held, and I wanted to hold it.
This is my first time competing for it.
Yeah, see, there
Hayden Vex cost me the opportunity.
Shut up.
I believe that.
Hayden Vex cost you a lot.
I can't shut up. It's my job, literally.
And there we have it. Eric Mason has had a stranglehold on the New Age title, like you said in the 10 minute, I'm sorry, counter begins. The match does have a 10-minute time limit, as Jackson Law murdered.
Oh my god! Brogan O'Shea just ran into a brick wall!
His physics teacher is rolling in his grave right now.
Ow.
Jesus.
Force equals mass times acceleration, but I think he just got accelerated right out of the damn ring.
Sir, I would not have done that.
I would not have done that either. I tried, and it didn't work too well for me.
Right.
Colorado tie-up. By the 2 men remaining, Eric Mason and Evan Phoenix in the ring.
They start getting tossed around. I think a title win would go well for any man in this ring, and Brogan O'Shea, I think, would be happy.
Especially after the first half of the year that Evan Phoenix has had, a title win here would be tremendous for him.
It was nice to see the return of the superhero come back at
correct.
SummerMania 18.
Absolutely. It was such a shot to the heart when he lost that money bank briefcase to Onyx.
Oh, yes.
But I feel it in my bones, JJ. This could be, the rest of this year could be for Evan Phoenix.
We'll see, like, rising from the ashes, like the Phoenix himself.
Look at this. Oh, beautiful European uppercut there by Evan Phoenix.
I have to say, a couple of those. Does he have a third one? No!
No! Forearm just takes down Phoenix, and here's the cover. One fall to a finish here.
The discus right there.
Jackson Law and Brogan O'Shea able to break that up.
Gotta make sure. Eric Mason's gotta make sure he keeps a close eye for these pinfalls.
That looks like it's Jackson and Brogan's turn to go one-on-one here.
Here we go, Brogan. Brogan O'Shea never wanted to shy away from a fight.
I don't know why Brogan's complaining about size. He's the smallest man in this match.
That's what he said.
Oh my god!
He said, why is everyone bigger than you, me? Huh?
But I think Brogan landed on his head.
Probably.
I think Brogan usually lands on his head. My god, Jackson turned him inside out.
He did a flip. Did you see that?
Jesus. Law of the land. No kidding.
Oh,
that's a long
god.
Arm.
Yes, sir.
Beautiful DDT there by Jackson Law. Cover by Jackson Law.
Oh, Eric Mason could lose his title right here.
Yeah, not even be involved in it. That's the problem with the Fatal 4-Way. There's no champion's advantage. Eric Mason could lose a match without even being in the ring.
Yeah, that's why he has to keep a close eye on these pinballs.
As Brogan O'Shea works on Jackson Law in that corner, here comes Brogan. Big elbow. Belfast Bulldog. Here it is. There's the cover.
Plants him like a tree.
Nope. After one, Jackson kicked out.
Brogan O'Shea. Compete pretty hard for a guy who doesn't want the New Age title.
It is actually kind of surprising to me how well Jackson is moving around considering how much he and Tommy beat the hell out of each other 2 weeks ago.
True, but he, like you said, he didn't have that 2 weeks.
Oh my god!
Oof!
Big, beautiful snap suplex. He's holding on for another.
Uh-oh. He's trying to get the trifecta here. Is he going to be able to do it?
Oh, my goodness.
Does he got one more in the tank?
He might.
We'll see, Eric. We'll see.
Picking him up again. Nope. Nope. Jack Swan reversed it. Into a suplex of his own. My God. Broken O'Shea unable to complete the three-leaf clover. Jackson Law cut him off.
Trying to get out, get some breathing room. Good maneuver there by Brogan O'Shea.
And Jackson Law stands alone in the ring. Well, he's kneeling alone in the ring, but he's alone in the ring is the point.
Yes, sir.
Hey, God, you stupid fuck.
Brogan.
Uh-oh.
Brogan said, you know what? I'm coming for you.
Uh-oh. Look out. Oh, my God! The Mason Express!
Yes, sir.
Is there, oh my God, the drive-by kick to us running Eric Mason.
Wait a minute. I gotta get
a replay on that, JJ.
That's the first time the Mason Express has been derailed. And oh,
here,
man.
Here it is again. Oh, my goodness.
Evan Phoenix hit the taunt there. But that was. See the impact. It's even worse on the replay.
My God, it is.
Oh, man.
Damn near got him in the face. More beautiful of a counter than that.
I think Evan Phoenix can, you know, take his time here. I think all the men laid to waste. Brogan O'Shea especially landing awkwardly. And then Mason, I'm sure not expecting that drive-by.
It's what we talked about earlier and what they discussed earlier. Cop versus superhero. Who's going to win out? Nobody yet.
Say, a law, the law of the land. You can't count him out.
No, you cannot.
It's like you said 2 weeks ago, that match you put.
Nice big boot to the face there by Evan Phoenix.
Through the ringer, and here he is. Again.
Good Lord. We got 5 minutes left. We're halfway through the time limit.
Yes, sir, and obviously.
Remember, the going the time limit would mean Eric Mason retains the New Age title.
That's what I was going to say. But.
What's going on here? Uh-oh.
5 minutes.
Mason back in. What is Broken do? What is he doing?
5 minutes is a long time, Eric. A lot can happen.
This crazy Irish bastard's at the top rope. Oh, my God. They caught him.
Uh-oh. That's not how it went.
Oh, my God.
See ya.
It's like a triple suplex.
They tried.
Jesus.
My God. Broken O'Shea. That didn't go
well. I know we already called one, but I got to see a replay on that as well. Let's get a replay on that one. My good. Yeah. Thank you, DJ Colin.
You're welcome. I got you.
Oh my goodness, man. The Brogan O'Shea got some height off of that.
He's been through the ringer in this match.
I think he's been up in the stratosphere.
Yes, sir. They keep tossing him. That's the Kavit there facing three other people that are bigger than you.
Brogan got the foot up on that exchange. What's he doing here?
Can he capitalize is the question.
Mason cut him off.
Uh-oh.
Oh, this is not going to be good. What's going to happen here?
He's going up.
Oh, no. Oh, my God. Beautiful superplex from the top. My God.
Sure you don't want to replay on that one, making a trifecta?
Jesus. Cover.
You couldn't have done that anymore.
Oh, my God. That was so close.
How the hell did Brogan kick out of that?
The replay gods have blessed us. Here it is again. My goodness. Beautiful superplex there by Eric Mason on Brogan O'Shea.
Well, hey, when the moves are that good, you just gotta get the replays going.
Brogan O'Shea's getting his frequent flyer miles on today.
100%. You gotta wonder how much he has left in the tank, Eric. He has been in almost every altercation in this match.
It's true. Jackson Law just got sent head first into the ring post on the outside by Evan Phoenix. Meanwhile, Brogan O'Shea. Oh my goodness.
Good maneuver using the momentum against him, trying to take the big man down.
That was that Irish car bomb. I haven't seen him do that in a long while.
About to say. Good to have you on the table, Eric.
Thank you.
Good to have you on the table.
I appreciate
that. Come on.
It's good to be here.
Come on.
What's the time check, though? How are we looking at it.
We're roughly about 2.5 minutes left.
2.5 minutes left, ladies and gentlemen. 3/4 of the way to do this contest.
Jackson with the DDT. Look out. Here we go. Evan Phoenix on the outside.
Yes, sir.
You got to have eyes in the back of your head. Oh. DDT on the apron. You know that's the hardest part of the ring, right?
100%. You know, you would know, being the...
I would know, yes. I've taken many a spill out there.
Yes, sir. I'm sure Brogan, he's been
a... Evan Phoenix!
Oh, he's going for the cover!
Shooting half, one, two, and no! My goodness, that was close.
Close.
We almost had a new age champ.
I'm about to say close.
We'll try Eric Mason now. Cover, one, two, and no!
You miss 100% of the shots you don't
That's
take.
That's true.
And you might as well all the men lay to waste as the crowd's starting to get behind Evan Phoenix a little bit here.
Tremendous action here from these four superstars in the ring here today at High Stakes.
What a high stakes it has been. Hey,
yes, sir. Beautiful.
Wait a minute.
That was the
Deadeye Knee.
That was the Deadeye Knee. Jackson Law's own finishing maneuver.
What a
can Evan Phoenix capitalize here?
Oh, man.
Just puts the head across the chest, too, and no. Brogan and Eric there again.
One of the most brutal moves in the galaxy, if you ask me. It just always looks so... Duh, destructive.
You think it's over and you forget the other two men in the back of your head. That's the fatal four-way for you. We're at a minute 15 left. My goodness.
This match is flying by.
This match has flown by, and what action have we seen here?
That's what I'm saying. Three replays. This for the New Age title, a new person belt.
Oh, wait a minute. I think Evan Phoenix is setting up for the...
My name's not Aaron.
For the Haluva kick. There it was.
We know.
My bad, dude. My bad. Oh, my God. Last call there from Brogan O'Shea. Did I need Eric Mason?
Oh, see ya.
Who's going to take the pin? We got about 40 seconds left. Cover. No.
This is a madhouse. It's a sprint to the
Brogan
finish.
Brogan trying to cover. No. Evan Phoenix not going to let it happen. Evan Phoenix with the cover. No.
Oh, Christ almighty. It's just a
30
a
seconds.
Madhouse. They're just throwing logic out the window. It's just whoever the hell can get
they
on top.
They can't decide who wants to take the pin over the New Age champion.
Who's going
to
get on top of Eric Mason?
Hopefully his girl. My God. Jackson Law fighting off Phoenix and Brogan O'Shea. Brogan for the cover again, but no.
The time just keeps ticking away.
7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and it is over. Ladies and gentlemen, the match has gone to the 10 minutes.
Time has expired. Therefore, it is a no contest.
What?
And still, your NCW New Age Champion, Eric Mason!
Fuck this! Valiant effort by the other three men in the match, Brogan O'Shea, Jackson Law, and Evan Phoenix. Thank you. But Eric Mason able to last the entire 10 minutes and retain the XCW New Age Championship. What a match.
First time it's went the distance in a while, too. We normally have a pinfall or something. But man, I want that match to end.
You gotta wonder, can Eric Mason survive long enough to cash that in on the international champion? Right now, his best friend, Hunter Halkin. Hey, we got more high stakes coming your way. Don't go anywhere.
Hello. You look a little agitated.
Shut the fuck up.
Okay.
I want you to understand something. This EBW shit, this is on you. You hear me? On you. What happened in my match should have never happened. Brady should have never been put in the match. He didn't even get the money in the bank legally. And you still allowed it to happen. I should still be world champion, not Brady Branson. Chris Jones shouldn't even be back. I should literally beat the shit out of you and run your ass out of this company.
Whoa. You know, while you may be right about Brady shouldn't have been in the match, Chris Jones had no business returning. I won Extreme King. I was the one who was pinned in that match. I'm the one who got super kicked. If anyone should be upset, it should be me. If anyone feels they should be XCW champion, it's not you. It's me.
But you got pinned. Your ass should be at the bottom of the pole now. I'm the one who should get the rematch. I'm the former champion.
Okay. Tone down a little, please. Got some good information.
Here's Touch me again, I'm going to fucking kill you.
Here's what we're going to do. Here's what we'll do tonight. We have ACT versus Corey Lee. And the winner will get a number one contendership for the XCW Championship. You never lost rightfully. You never lost rightfully. So I'm giving you both a chance. So you better take that chance and run. Because I don't want to hear you back in here again yelling and bitching at me. I got enough on my plate. spin the wheel.
Go ahead.
Spin the wheel. I quit.
You know, that's great, because now not only do I need to pin you or submit you, I just have to make you utter the words, I quit. I get to humiliate you and prove why I should be the rightful number one contender.
You know, you can wear your little ACT and talk your little scholar bullshit, but when it comes down to it out in that ring, I'm miles above you. You're not gonna beat me. In fact, you'll be the one saying I quit, not me. I'm going to make sure that you say those words, because I'm going to be world champion. Not you. Not in a million years will you ever be head of this company.
The following match is a mystery opponent match. Introducing your NCW International Champion.
Back with the gold.
He hails from Shelbyville, Indiana. Hunter Halkin.
Hunter Halkin, coming off of a star-making performance at SummerMania in that TLC match with Brogan.
Sir Eric, what about that match, man? Silencing all the haters and showing why he is the one to win the title right there.
That's right. I think Hunter's got something to say here.
Interesting.
Love you, Hunter!
I love you too.
Well, well, well. It's been a long 2 weeks. Long 2 weeks. Recovery. Realizing what's truly happened at SummerMania. I showed you all who I really am. Not only am I the guy that can be the happy face that can bring any smiles to any kids, I can bring absolute destruction with that too. But that leads me to where I am today. Today, when I spun that wheel and I decided to pick my fate, I got a mystery opponent. A mystery opponent that could be anybody in XCW's past, current, or present. So now, I'm gonna say one more thing. Whoever it is back there, you better be international champion contender material, because I'm putting this belt on the line tonight!
Oh my god! JJ, Hunter Halkin has just put the international championship on the line!
So bring him out here! So he can level up.
The stakes were already high, and here we go.
I mean, that's the name of the show. But now, whoever's coming out here is about to be in a title match, and they didn't even know it. Oh, wait a minute.
Now, wait a
minute. It's SAT.
The brother.
It's not Anthony Thompson.
We haven't seen this man.
He faced Jacoby. No, oh, my God. Oh, my Lord. Right off the bat.
Things under control here. SAT coming out like a ball of fire. Maybe the international title has him incensed over here. Losing sight, but man.
The stakes are super high now. The international championship on the line. Yeah. My goodness. I don't know, Halkin didn't even have a chance to get his jacket off
ready?
Before SAT attacked him.
Are you ready?
SAT never
won. Bring the belt on!
And now Hunter Halkin, oh my goodness!
See you.
Charges and SAT able to duck him cross body.
Ooh,
Jacoby on the pre-show of SummerMania 18.
Yes, sir, the final match.
And a loss to him. SAT must be fired up after that loss.
Oh, yeah, trying to get a W here.
Trying to win the international title.
Oh, yeah. I think the stakes were high enough. Definitely got something to prove here. My God!
God, spiked him on his head. That could be enough. SAT could win the title here. No.
Two!
But, yeah, that awkward neck landing there, Eric.
Keep dreaming, buddy.
Uh-oh.
SAT looking like the SAT of old, I gotta tell you.
SAT tried to argue with the ref. Wow. I know that he did well for him. There we go!
Take down by Hunter Halkin, laying in those right hands.
Come on!
That's what I'm talking about.
There we go! The crowd is fired up for Hunter Halkin.
Ever since that match with Brogan O'Shea, definitely see Hunter put it on.
So beautiful suplex by Halkin.
Is he ever going to be able? Is he going to be able to put down SAT?
Hey,
it's a tall ask. Remember a couple years ago when ACT fought?
Yeah, huh? Oh,
man. Oh!
Let's just shut up!
That was like a firework. Slider's listening to the crowd. Oh, my God. That's a great way to lose a nipple.
Yes. Feeling exceptionally sadistic tonight.
And, Bronco Buster in the corner. Hunter Halkins fired up. Uh-oh. He could have him here. Cover.
One, two.
No, SAT. Two. Able to get that shoulder up.
Another close contest. Good seeing these two in a ring here.
Don't forget, Scott Anthony. Oh, my God. X Factor there by Hunter Halkins.
Sir.
How he going up? No, he's not. He's going for that Rolling Thunder splash.
And there he goes,
him here.
Trying to end
one,
it.
Two, and no.
God. Two.
How close was that?
Sir, I said both of these men been in the same battle royale.
As I was
going to
mention, SAT, a former tag team champion. Let's not forget, he has won gold here in XCW.
Yes, sir. Yes. Had the occasional match here lately, so this is his first foray.
Speaking of gold, former XCW Championship League and ACT's won an I Quit match. We're going to see that later on tonight. I can't wait for that one. My God. SAT. Going to take a page out of his brother's book with the face wash right to Hunter Halkin.
Sir, throwing that cake around is going to be enough. ACT and SAT, remember, their relationship didn't end so well, Eric.
That's very true.
Who knows, though, with the tag team division the way it is, maybe we could see a little brotherly return. Who knows?
Well, time will only tell.
And so
for right now, Scott Anthony Thompson, proving to be the formidable challenger for Hunter Halkin's championship.
But can he knock off?
Mounting those punches.
Can he knock off the international champion?
Come on, Hunter.
One. Steve.
Oh, my goodness. Oh! DDT. Straight into the DDT cover.
One.
We have a new champion here right here.
Two.
I thought we had a new champion.
SAT. Really
SAT.
Giving him a run for his money.
Correct. This close to tasting his first singles gold.
I say, could you imagine? Coming in, you don't know that you might walk out with the international title tonight.
God.
You're just here trying to make a statement. What a statement the international title would be here.
Oh,
he went for the curb stomp.
SAT swatted him out of midair. Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Oh, my God. The final note. No, he couldn't get it off.
Hunter Halkin, there we go.
Roll up by Hunter Halkin.
Here we go.
Stacked him up. Number one, two, and no. Oh, my God. That was
close, but no cigar.
Curb stomp. He's got it covered. Two. He's got it.
The winner of this match as the result of a pinfall. And still the XCW International Champion, Hunter Halkin!
Outstanding job by a champion, Hunter Halkin. You cannot take anything away from Scott Anthony Thompson. He was a very game performer here today, but of course, Hunter Halkin
fresh off of that one, Summer Rae. I can put out.
What? One, I feel he's about to go on, Eric. Oh, man, the international title looks good on it.
Well, we got tag team action soon to come here at High Stakes. Hey, don't go anywhere more right after this.
Oh, yeah. Can't tell you how much it means to me to be part of EVW, for you helped me achieve this from the likes of Corey Lee and ACT. We really stuck it to XCW this time.
We definitely did.
And something nobody ever expected. Like, you and I definitely not eye to eye completely, but to have a partner that I can appreciate just as much as Gabe when it comes to something like this, I can respect your tenacity. And Fletch's old washed up business, I have nothing nothing left to prove in XCW. We pulled the wool over their eyes, and it's been going on for a while now. Nobody even remotely expected it.
Yeah.
Oh, what's up, man?
Welcome back. Welcome back.
Good to see you, man.
Some new colors, man.
Well, a little orange, man.
It's OGs, dude. You know, I was on the phone with him for weeks. I knew this was coming. But to tell you the truth, bro, I don't know if I can rock your colors.
My colors? These aren't my colors. These are our colors. We're not just Extreme Backyard Wrestling anymore. We're more than that. We're elite. And just like you're an OG, I'm an OG day one.
Right.
You and I have been to wars over what this means to us. I'd say this means more to you than it truly does to him.
Or him.
But you've been there since day one. You've been by my side. No one expects Chris to have a right-hand soldier other than James Cerebral. It's just a new color, man. We'll give you a chance to, what do you think about giving him a chance?
I mean,
you're the man with ideas.
I've been talking to him for weeks on phone, man. I told you, I know that you can bring something to EVW. And like you said, you're the OG. Sure, you might not like the orange colors and everything, but like, you know, you said yourself, the past is doomed to repeat itself.
10-year anniversary.
That's right, and you know, sometimes it's just a different color.
Oh, man.
Well, we'll give you a chance to prove yourself, because just like you know, the Untouchables, EBW, same motto. You're with us, or are you gonna end up on the wrong side? The side that James Cerebral has never been on. I know you know what I'm saying.
So, it sounds like a threat, almost.
You know what I'm about. Ain't nobody stay G'd up like Cerebral.
True that.
So, we got some business. You think, you ponder back here, you know where to find us.
Give me a call, Mr. Cerebral, when you think it through.
Well, I did not expect that one.
I guess that James Cerebral thinks that the new EBW is tainting the legacy of the old one. He's a little unsure about joining this one, huh?
Yeah, I thought he would jump at the opportunity, you know, being a legacy.
Again, we mentioned it earlier, he's been wearing the shirt the whole year. He's been repping the brand the whole year. You would have thought he would have been among the first to join EBW, but now we think he might not even join the brand at all.
Especially since he's been getting opportunities. Unsure? I mean, you figure if he was really going to do it, he would have just, like you said, jumped at the opportunity, said yes, and thrown that in those new colors on. But, well, only time will tell, I guess.
Only time will tell. Hey, we got tag team action coming up right now. Onyx and Fletch taking on the EBW team of Hayden Vex and Brady Branson. Hey, let's get right to that.
The following match is a tag team match scheduled for one fall. Introducing the first team. Making his way to the ring first. Coming in at a weight of 298 pounds, he hails from Detroit, Michigan.
He is the symbol of excellence, yes, but more importantly, he is battle-tested. And even though he didn't come away with the win at Summer Mania against Justin Fursley, he is ready for action here tonight, JJ.
Sir, you saw him quickly. He jumped to Onyx's defense after EBW attacked him, man.
Well, he wasn't kidding. He said it. Onyx is his blood. That is for real, folks. They are blood.
And introducing his tag team partner. Making his way to the ring, coming in at a weight of 185 pounds, he hails from Shelbyville, Indiana. He is forgotten no more. Onyx!
We saw Onyx at the start of today's program having a little issue with his former manager, Luke Blaze, who is now, as we know, the financier of EBW. I can't imagine what is going through Onyx's
head. And introducing their opponents. Making their way to the ring, being accompanied by the EBW benefactor, Luke Blaze. They are at a combined weight of 507 pounds. They are the natural born killer, Hayden Vex, and your XCW champion, breakaway Brady Braxton.
Championship.
I gotta wonder what's going through Onyx. He said 2 weeks ago he was Money in the Bank holder. He had it all. We glossed over his win. He beat Jaden Tucker in Summer Mania to win a Hardcore Championship.
It's chilling!
And now, look, I can't imagine what Onyx is feeling right now.
A broken man, but Luke Blaze, I think, had it right. The rise of Onyx this year. I don't think he's just gonna crash and burn.
Well, I hope Onyx ends up being his undoing. It would only be poetic.
We'll have to see if Fletch and Onyx can pick up a win. First of many, hopefully, XCW versus EBW wins.
You ready?
Onyx. But I will say,
ring the bell!
They have the EBW and the XCW championship.
Gotta wonder if Hayden Vex is 100% because he had a brutal Texas death match 2 weeks ago with some guy, I forget his name.
Yeah, Black Card, I think. Yeah, that was a hellacious match, though.
It was. I'm still feeling it. It's been 2 weeks.
100%. A lot of emotion in that match. I mean, I think we're still recovering.
Absolutely. Scumbag cheating by EBW.
I know, he's trying.
Fletch, unfortunately, unwittingly doing his tag partner more harm than good, unfortunately.
Ref Brooke trying to keep some order in here, and unfortunately plays right into EBW's hand. The ones that are going to try, cheat, and steal to do whatever they can.
Oh, and the breakaway slam by Brady Branson. Cover.
Sir. Brady Branson, what a change he's went to this year.
Can you imagine what it would do for Onyx if he could pin the XCW champion here in this match?
It would be huge. Of course, you wouldn't win the title, but no. the prestige.
But that would be a big stepping stone on the way to possibly getting into that picture.
Oh, yeah, and it would almost
end
EBW, the champion already defeated. Oh.
I have never agreed with a crowd chant more.
EBW's house.
That's right.
It's not what the signs on the fence say.
Well, I'm sure they've got some on the way.
And those will change eventually too.
Told you.
Oh, disrespect. Slap to the face of Fletch. Fletch isn't even the legal man in the match.
I have to say, just making
absolutely despicable tactics from EBW.
They're making a mockery of the rules here.
The only thing they're elite at is bending the rules.
Come on.
Extremely boring wrestling, if you ask me.
Oh, I see what you did there. I like that. And we are explosive here, as always, ladies and gentlemen.
Always have been, always will be, to the end. Oh my god.
Oh my god, what I said, bro!
That was a brainbuster suplex, by the way. Cover.
Murdered him. Brady Branson long enough just to help Hayden Vex with that suplex.
Onyx desperately needs a tag. Backbreaker by Hayden Vex. As the crowd desperately tries to get behind. Onyx.
Brady Branson, possibly the biggest winner of Summer Mania.
I mean the biggest whiner.
Yeah, the biggest whiner, I apologize.
Yeah.
Thanks to Chris Jones' interference coming out with the XCW Championship and then the specter of
WWE. Can we talk about the way he managed to whine his way into the main event as well? Complained the whole show about not having a match and ended up winning the XCW title in a match he wasn't even supposed to be in.
There you go.
Just drops Onyx.
Count is there!
That's such a lackadaisical cover.
And you know that only in the most extreme circumstances will that work, but it's about the sending a message. And I think Onyx is getting the message. Flesh needs a tag in the worst way here. Onyx,
no kidding.
He might die. But EBW doing a great job of keeping him away.
As much guff as you want to give Hayden Vex and Brady Branson, they are extremely accomplished in the ring after that T-bone suplex, my 100%. God.
Multiple, both of them held XCW championships.
Yeah, one of them holding it right now.
100%. For what, the third time, I believe?
Yep, tag into Brady Branson. Yes, he is a three-time XCW champion.
Yeah, some people never hold it once. He's got it three times. And he's an EBW. Oh, it makes me sick.
It makes me sick that he has our most prestigious championship. Jesus.
My God, that felt personal, Mike. Or Eric.
Come on, this is your blood. Huh?
I said that felt personal.
That's Mike. I'm Eric.
Is this?
That's a microphone.
What? Is this what I've been talking
about? Yes. Brady Branson. Oh, Onyx is trying to come back. Oh!
That's what we want to see.
Can Onyx make the tag, though? He's a long way away from Fletch.
I'm about to say they're both on the opposite side, unfortunately.
Unfortunately, a Brady Branson between Brady Branson is going to try to crawl for the tag to Hayden Vex.
Can he get it? Can he get
it? Whoever gets the tag first is going to have the advantage here. Hayden's got the tag. Can Onyx get the tag? No, Hayden cuts him off. My God.
No, dang. That's not what Onyx and Fletch needed.
And Hayden immediately going to town, elbows to the knees. Oh, my God.
That's tough to watch.
This is tough to
watch. Do you get? Do
you get? No. Look at your family now.
Why does Hayden
Vex have to get so personal? He did it with me. He's doing it with Fletch. It's ridiculous.
Come on,
it's all about
it's ridiculous. Fletch trying to will Onyx over to the corner to get that tag, but Hayden Vex just not allowing it. Tag back into Brady Branson.
There we go. Hayden Vex just holding him up. So Brady Branson got a free cheap shot in there.
Kiss my ass.
Referee Brooke trying to keep peace as much as possible, but this is EBW talking about. They're not going to play fair.
Not at all. Not in the slightest
are they going to play fair. They're not about playing fair.
Oh, right on the chest.
Look at this.
The big forearms there. Oh, wait a minute.
Trying to fight out of it. Oh, beautiful clothesline takes down Brady, but he tags into Hayden. Onyx really needs a tag.
Man.
Oh, no, I thought he tagged into Hayden. Maybe he didn't.
Close, but no cigar.
No tag there. Thank you. Referee broke on top of things. Another clothesline by Onyx. Can Onyx get over to the corner and tag in his partner, Fletch? He's got to get that tag. He's desperate at this point.
Brady, definitely the guard there, making sure that Onyx doesn't get anywhere near Fletch. And unfortunately...
Side headlock. Back into the corner, Fletch finally able to get that tag. Desperately needed to Fletch.
Come on, keep it
on. Keep it on Brady Branson. Kicks in the corner.
Now, Onyx can get a little break finally.
Telling Hayden Vex is number one. Cannonball into the corner.
That is right. We've seen it before. And Fletch on the warpath. This is exactly what he was waiting for.
Beautiful flipping neck breaker there by Fletch. Cover one, two, and no. And almost had the three count on the XCW champion.
Kudos
and of course, Brady with the right to the eyes.
Kudos to Fletch for trying to put it away.
Fletch is blinded. He can't see.
You saw him try to take a couple swipes there, but you could tell he was flying blind as Brady Branson, the despicable X, just continued.
This is absolutely ridiculous.
This is what we've come to expect for BBW, but maybe this is what James Cerebral was talking about. This seems a little more, I don't know, evil than last time.
I can't believe this, but I kind of agree with James Cerebral on that.
Yep.
Oh my goodness.
Yes, count him out!
Uh-oh.
Cover two and no! Fletch able to kick out.
Thank goodness.
After the bleach the colors,
Man, Brady Branson.
I gotta wonder how much these two got left in the tank. Fletch and Brady trading blows now. Ooh.
He's gonna come out on top of the slobber knocker here.
Brady was trying to spit shot, but he couldn't produce any spit, so Fletch just drop kicked him.
That's what you try to do when you do somebody's move, you know?
Hey, listen, that's what happens when the spit hits the fan.
I see what you did. Brady. I like that.
Fletch has got to stay on him here. He can't let Brady get that tag into Hayden Vex. That could be torture.
Hopefully this doesn't... Brady being an EBW doesn't taint the legacy of the XFL championship.
That would be a very useless area for him. Cover! Stacking him up! One, two, no! Fletch just in time, my god.
That was close. Even with the extra push there, Fletch still able to kick out. You love to see it. You love to see it. Obviously,
Fletch is brave and obstacles.
Last time. Oh!
Tag into Onyx!
That's what they needed. The last time EBW invaded, almost the end of XCW.
Tag into Hayden Vex!
Funny enough, Corey was the salvation. Corey Lee. I wonder if that'll happen this time. I doubt it.
We'll just have to see. Right now, he's got to worry about ACT and I quit match tonight. Skybridge! Powerbomb! My god! Cover! Two!
Get a replay on that gut wrench, holy.
Yes, please.
My god, the strength. I mean, I know, you know, Onyx isn't 300 pounds, but Jesus.
That takes a lot of effort to power somebody up there, even if they're 185 like Onyx is.
I was about to say, that's probably soaking wet.
Oh my god, look at this.
The roll up,
cover one, two, and no. I thought he had him,
We've seen the roll up. We've seen it claim many a victim, Eric. I'm sure yourself included.
Yeah. In fact, could be going for that Falcon Arrow. He got it barely.
Oh, he stalled with it a little bit.
I think Hayden's a little low on gas. Cover two and low again. Onyx able to get that shoulder up. My God, what's it gonna take?
You cannot keep Onyx down.
Onyx is an Energizer Bunny. He just won't quit.
That's exactly what Fletch needs right now.
And now the double team.
BBW.
Oh my god.
Again, here we go. Pulling out all the stops.
Look at this. Jesus.
Christ almighty.
The Pure and the Prejudice slam. It could be enough. Two and no, he kicked out again. My god.
Pure is right. Oh my lord.
Onyx is taking the beating of his life and he keeps kicking out.
He's on pure adrenaline right now. Oh my lord.
Brady Branson is beside himself.
Shut up!
He can't understand why Onyx won't stay down.
I can't understand. I'm impressed. He has taken pretty much everything these men have to offer. And still he kicks out. He gets out. And look at this!
Natural selection by Onyx could be enough cover. One. Oh, Brady on the ropes.
Man, I thought that might be it.
For God's sakes. Onyx cannot catch a break here.
Brady Branson, always the ring awareness. He's got eyes in the back of his head. And Onyx has just got to do a little bit more.
What's he doing here? Oh, my God. The last cantering. He's got it locked in! But here comes Hayden Vex. Wait a minute, come on!
You gotta hate him.
Yeah, you do. You do gotta hate him.
Because, man, that was... That was amazing. That could have been it there. The acrobatics by Onyx. But Hayden Vex...
It's you.
Just can't let it go.
Oh, and Brady Branson was
come on! Absolutely.
Over the top rope.
Fletch wasn't even in, and Ref Brooke distracted by that.
No.
Show
this?
Here is Hayden.
Oh, what a power slam by Hayden Beck. Not even the legal man. What a miserable son of a...
Don't say it. This is a family show.
I don't know about that. I've seen a man get almost stabbed about it, but still.
Yeah, but he didn't. Did he die?
No, he didn't.
Exactly. If he dies, it wouldn't be a lot of shit.
Brady Branson's going on top. I very rarely see him do this. What is he doing?
And after taking out Fletch, this could be the exclamation point on this match, Eric.
This could be exclamation point on his forehead if he messes this up.
I was about to say, no pressure.
Elbow drop from the top rope. Plants
Man,
Onyx right in the heart.
Absolutely destroys in there.
Branson's slow to cover. Here we go, cover. One. No, Onyx able to get him shot up again.
Onyx, you hate to see it. You hate to see it.
No, you love to see Onyx kicking out. I don't know where he's getting this from, JJ.
He is just like tapping into something primal right now.
My goodness.
Onyx, the elbow drop.
Tag it to Fletch, he's got it. Tag it to Hayden. Hayden and Fletch are the legal men here.
We go!
Come on, Fletch is fired up!
He's going for Hayden Beck. Oh, wait!
Oh, no. Oh my God! The lie down followed by the death by Beck.
And
oh,
that's
no.
Gotta be it.
No.
It's the legal
no.
Man!
Damn it! Oh. Damn it!
That's not what
the
we wanted.
The winners of this match, as a result of a pinfall, the team of Brady Branson and Hayden Banks, E.B.W.
Suffice to say, JJ, if this keeps happening, XCW has a major problem on their hands.
Talking about EBW, the first time was almost the end, the doom of XCW, and this time it's going to finally be the nail in the coffin. EBW standing tall. I hope this isn't a sight we see a lot. With themselves. But, don't worry, like you said, Eric, we have that I Quit match coming up right after this, and you don't want to miss it.
Oh my God!
What happened? Fletch, are you okay?
What happened is right.
Are you okay? Are you okay, man?
Fletch back here on the ladder. Backstage, I don't know.
Are you okay? We need help, guys, come on!
I don't know who did this, but it smells like the work of EBW, if you ask me.
Okay.
I cannot believe this.
Come on, guys, we need help. I need someone, I need medical. I need someone.
We gotta get some help back there for Fletch.
Come on, Fletch. Come on!
The following match is an I Quit match. Making his way to the ring first. Coming in at a weight of 225 pounds, he hails from Harvard University and is the scholar of XCW, Alex Cardona Thompson, A.C.T.
You wanna know who I feel the most sorry for, JJ?
Who?
That man right there. Had everything going his way. Extreme King winner. Was in the main event of Summer Mania and had
and introducing
taken from
his opponent.
EBW.
Funny thing is, you could also say the same about this man. It's snowing again? Why does it do that every time?
Making his way to from Boise, Idaho, Corey Lee!
Hey, Paolo!
I mean, whether you love him or you hate him, he's got a legitimate gripe. Brady was never supposed to be in that match. Corey lost his title to a man who he wasn't expecting to face.
Yeah, and you even had Chris Jones come out and cost him the match, arguably pointing it in Brady's favor. It was not Brady's match to win, I would almost guarantee it.
Absolutely. Corey Lee has a legitimate gripe. Legitimate gripe with how SummerMania turned out for him.
Same thing, like you said, ACT. Brady inserted himself in that match.
Both of these men, one of them should be XCW champion and not Brady Branson.
I should be XCW champion, not Brady Branson, not ACT. Fuck EBW. And fuck XCW.
Okay, I don't agree with that.
You won't be the salvation this time, I guess.
No, guess not. I agree with the EBW sentiment, at least, though.
All right, we got these two in an I Quit match.
He still got Rob. There's no rules in this match. No pinfalls, no submissions, no countouts, no disqualifications. Anything goes. You just got to make your opponent say, I quit. And RefFest does have a microphone on hand so that these competitors can say I quit into it if necessary, when necessary. Ooh. He's in the midsection already starting out.
You gotta love it. You gotta love it. And don't forget that main event, ladies and gentlemen. Chris Jones defending the EBW title against Miyano Diaz.
Already going to the outside. Corey Lee's got a chain. Corey Lee has a chain. He's got it wrapped around ACT's neck. Cutting off that airflow.
What do you say, ACT?
Like you said, everything's legal.
Can't say anything if he's choking to death.
You quit?
Say it. No. Say it. No.
You quit?
No, ACT not giving up yet.
You love to see it. You love to see it. Especially.
Oh, look out. Oh my God. Stampeded him over the top rope to the ground, and now Corey Lee gets a taste of his own medicine.
You love to see it. Corey Lee.
Quit, Corey.
No.
Being choked.
Kids are openly berating Corey Lee here. I can't blame him too much, I guess.
Well, he doesn't like the Galaxy and they don't like him.
That's fair. It's a real nice understanding they have.
Yeah, 100%. You know, it's nice. It's nice.
ACT, gotta stay on Corey. Corey is no slouch. He's a 7-time XCW champion for real. Oh, look at this crossbody. We saw it. No, not crossbody. Dropkick. Changing it up a little bit.
It's gonna take a lot for him to say, I quit.
Corey's been through a lot too in his career. It's gonna take a lot for him to say, I quit. I guarantee that. Dude's had surgery on his knee. Oh, low blow.
Oh, man.
Completely legal. There's nothing that the referee can do about it. It's an I quit match. So is this chain. Oh, about to emblazon into the head of ACT.
ACT was going before Corey Lee steals it from him.
Good Lord. Galaxy letting him have it, letting Corey Lee hear how dissatisfied they are. ACT eats ring post.
Man, I don't even know if EBW would want Corey Lee after his words tonight.
He never wanted him in the first place. He's the reason they died the last time.
100%, which is why would you not want that person? The ultimate betrayal.
We already know Corey Lee doesn't like EBW. But we now know he sides with no man. Corey Lee is very much an island.
He is an island, yes.
Not even the EBW title. It's just the world championship that belongs to me.
No, not that. I want a chair right across the shoulder blades of ACT.
Ouch.
Referee better get in there and check in ACT and see if he gives up.
Might be dead.
No. Corey Lee's going to continue to work on him.
Not giving him the chance. Good maneuver there. Put him away. Oh, he's keeping that chair close by. What is he going to be doing to ACT here?
Corey Lee knows his way around weapons. I mean, I've had a hardcore match with him a couple years ago. You remember at Ground Zero, I wrestled him. He beat the hell out of me with chairs and signs and doing stuff like this. The coup de grace on the chair. My God.
Ouch, ouch, ouch.
The movie maker. Well, it's not the movie maker now, but it used to be.
Devil Slayer.
There you go, Devil Slayer.
I remember
I like
that.
It.
I remember that.
I like it, I love it.
Oh, you want some more of it?
No, I don't know about that. I felt that plenty of times in my career.
ACT.
It never feels good. Oh! Oh!
Oh, but it landed. It hit him right in the...
I think Corey Lee avoided disaster there, but not for long. ACT. Going to town on that. That's the knee. That's the knee Corey's had surgery on. ACT knows that. He is the scholar for a reason.
Yes, sir. He is one of the most intelligent wrestlers. He doesn't just say it. It's true.
Absolutely true. DDT to the foot of Corey Lee.
Both of these men, like you said, Brady Branson unfairly inserted into their match, been fighting hellaciously back and forth. ACT, after winning the Extreme King and earning his title shot, even defending, he put that contendership on the line. And to still be robbed. It was just, like you said, despicable, Eric, despicable.
Very. ACT doing the smart thing and continuing to work on that knee, my God.
Corey Lee might be in some trouble here.
Using the backside of that chair to hit that knee. That's even worse.
Man, the wheel was not kind to our people today.
No, absolutely not.
Oh, man.
Speaking of wheel, Corey's got a real bad one right now.
He's trying to, hopefully he can put some weight on it and get up, or
looks
I don't
like,
know.
Looks like he's trying to. I don't know how well that's working out for him. Nope, it's not. Corey's having trouble putting weight on that knee.
That might be it for him.
Is that a toilet seat? I think I remember that toilet seat. I think it was wrapped around my head 2 weeks ago.
I might be able to quit.
It's where my... Oh, my God.
Uh-oh.
Oh, it's not that with the toilet seat, but Corey's knee gave out.
Oh.
It doesn't matter if he can capitalize. He's got to... ACT's got to say, I quit.
Hopefully he didn't re-injure that knee. Uh-oh.
We're yelling at the ref to ask.
ACT?
No. ACT not giving up yet.
Corey Lee. He thought he had it there. He told Festus to ask him.
Come on, Corey. Corey wants this to end sooner than later because that knee, he's favoring it heavily right now.
Oh, yeah. Is Corey Lee going to be the one to quit? I mean, this really could change the whole dynamic of the match.
I don't know. I for some reason, I just don't see Corey Lee doing that. Oh! Went for that knee, that running knee, but ACT countered it with the toilet seat lid.
He's got no knees now at this point. Jesus.
Uh-oh. Here we go. Oh, he's going for that hidden blade. Yes. Missed it. Oh, and the effing on the back.
Yes,
but again,
sir.
But on the knees. The more he does that, the more it's going to hurt him.
So he needs to make sure that the next thing he does puts ACT down, or Corey Lee may be the one saying, I quit.
My God.
Or his knee, anyway, might say, I quit.
His knee might already be screaming, I'll be honest. Look at this. What is he doing here?
Using the chains to
his advantage. Put the rings of sobriety on him with the chains? Oh my God! He's got it locked in! Rings of sobriety with the chains!
No!
Give up!
No!
Yeah. Really trying to lock it in.
No!
You can see the pain in Corey Lee's face. He wants this to end. He wants ACT to give up. ACT's not giving up! ACT able to get out of the rings. Yeah. Oh,
that's what I'm talking about. Gives him enough room to kind of get his bearings.
Is that what they mean when they say it's off the chain?
I think so.
This match is off the chain. ACT trying to get the crowd back into it here.
Both
trying
men,
to get the crowd to will him back to his feet.
Both men slowly getting there. But who is going to be the first one? Corey Lee still with the knee.
Kick to the knee and a suplex by ACT.
Again with the knee, you love to see it. That intelligence playing in full effect there.
I don't care.
But Corey Lee doesn't look like he's ready to give up quite yet.
ACT trying to stay in control here, going for that last shot. There it is, he's nailed it.
Oh yes, sir, he hits that.
You say it, ask him.
You quit, Corey.
No.
No, Corey does not quit.
Sir finds pay dirt there, and oh man, it's not enough to knock Corey Lee out though. Corey Lee again refusing to give up.
Can't Can Corey even get back to a vertical base at this point? That knee's got to be destroyed.
Both of these men look like they've almost out of gas here.
I quit matches take it out of you. They're brutal affairs. This one has been for sure so far. What is he doing? Oh my! Oh wait a minute! Oh my God! What a spinebuster! He was going
for the take one.
That's right.
Corey, did you quit? Fuck you.
Oh, defiance.
Technically, that's not a yes or a no, defiance, but I'll take it as a no.
Defiance from the anti-savior. As ACT continues to work that knee over.
Corey Lee has to be in a lot of pain right now.
I can't imagine. I cannot imagine how much pain Corey Lee is in.
Right, just even laying there. Not even alone standing up or trying to get up. Just laying there. I bet it's just agony. That?
Is he loading that for the hidden blade?
Cha-ching.
He's loading that for the hidden blade. There it is across the back of the head.
God.
He can't say I quit if he's out cold. But ACT could have him here.
Ask him. All you got to do.
Ref Fest is with the mic.
Corey, do you quit? Fuck XCW and fuck EBW. I think that's another
that's
no.
That's not an I quit, so the match continues.
I think that's a no.
That's a no.
I'm not doing.
As we said, Corey Lee, very much an island.
Deciding not to quit. I don't know, though. An interesting position he's taken. If he's not XCW, he's not EBW. I don't see XCW assaulting him, but he
can't. Oh, the running knee! With the bad knee, the bad knee that's been worked on the whole match.
Corey Lee, his knee, a big part of his repertoire here. He does a large part of his moveset.
Do you quit?
Based never. On that.
Never.
Says he never quits.
Says he never quits. We'll have to see if that holds true. What is Corey Lee doing? What is he grabbing?
He's going.
He's got that chair again.
Oh, another chair. ACT.
Uh-oh. Yeah, it might be the same one as the audience very helpfully pointed out. DDT on the chair, my God!
Right on it.
Concuss. Corey Lee could be out, like cold.
It looks like it. He's not moving. There's some twitches, but up.
Just muscle spasms.
Corey, what are you saying? Did he quit?
Very exasperated, no. Yeah, but
he barely even got that out.
Oh, no. Oh! Yeah! Good God! Oh! If Corey Lee's knee wasn't destroyed now, before, it definitely is now. No, he's gonna pilmanize him!
Corey Lee just has to decide what's worth it. Yeah, he might lose this match, but he could lose his.
Oh my God! Double stomp right on that chair! He could have a dislocated knee, he could have a broken or fractured. Kneecap.
Could be.
My God.
Fried. He should just give up. He should just say, "I quit."
What
is it worth
it? Look at this. Single leg Boston Crab, assisted by the chain. Nice line, Ben. Come on.
He's got to save his knee. Just quit.
Rope breaks don't matter. But I quit. I quit.
There he goes.
Cardona Thompson, ACT!
A measure of redemption for ACT after his devastating loss to Summer Mania comes back with a win in this brutal I Quit match.
EBW, you're next.
Oh, there you go.
The die is cast.
ACT's gonna stand up for ACT. In any event, we still got the main event to come, an EBW title match. Chris Jones will be in action for the first time in 2 years here in an XCW ring. Wait a minute.
Fuck XCW, fuck EBW, and fuck you, Chris Jones.
I agree with 2/3 of that. In any event, Chris Jones will be defending the EBW title against Miano Diaz right after a word from our social media.
The following match is your high-stakes main event, and it is for the EBW World Championship. Introducing first, the challenger. Making his way to the ring, being accompanied by Patrick O'Reilly, coming in at a weight of 125 pounds, he hails from Albuquerque, New Mexico, Miano Diaz.
These two beat the hell out of each other 2 weeks ago at Summermania. You can see the respect. Patrick is hardcore champ. He's got Onyx still to come because Onyx is number one contender, but right now the focus is on the EBW Championship.
And introducing your EBW World Champion.
I'ma worry about me, give a fuck about you, nigga, just as a reminder to myself. I wear every single chain, even when I'm in the house.
Making his way to the ring, being accompanied by Hayden Vex, Brady Branson, and Luke Blaze. Coming in at a weight of 200 pounds, he hails from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. He is the franchise player, Chris Jones.
Welcome back.
Chris Jones about to wrestle his first match in 2 years. He may not be XCW, but it is an XCW ring. Last time we saw him in action was against Brogan O'Shea just a couple years ago at Summermania. Wiping his butt on Miano Diaz's shirt. We all know why he picked Miano. Miano's the smallest man on the roster. But that's the thing, there's a lot of fight in Miano Diaz, and I hope to hell Miano Diaz shuts this man up permanently.
That would be nice, winning the EBW Championship. I mean, it's only fair that they have the XCW Championship.
The problem is at ringside. There's only two of Miano and Patrick. There's four of them.
Well, I don't know about Luke Blaze.
But you still got, you're still out, they're still outnumbered.
That's true.
You got Brady, you got Hayden, and Chris Jones. You're still outnumbered.
That's a pretty good starting three right there, too.
It's ridiculous.
The world XCW heavyweight champion. The world.
I do not envy Festus Davis here because he's going to have his hands full with the EBW guys at ringside.
100%. It's for the EBW title. As you know, Chris Jones, the last holder of that title. How gracious of him to put it on the line already.
Yeah, if you call that gracious.
Let's go, XC-Dub! XC-Dub, let's go!
That's what I'm talking about.
I would not jaw jack with Brady and Hayden.
XC-Dub! If they chant again, I'll walk out of the arena. XC-W!
Can we enact a rule where the count-out makes the title change hands? That'd be nice.
We could try. Why not?
Ring the bell.
It's CPW.
Go,
Miano! Chris Jones about to wrestle for the first time in 2 years since his loss at the hands of Brogan O'Shea at Summermania 2 years ago. Brogan O'Shea not very happy about that, by the way. We saw him earlier.
Oh, I wonder if he ever found Chris Jones.
He can find him right now. He's in the ring with Miano.
Right.
Look at this.
So did we ever get any?
Beautiful arm drag, and Chris Jones goes flying out of the ring.
Yes.
Let's go!
I tried for years to get a match with Chris Jones, and he just hands me on Diaz.
Wow.
I'm a little salty, JJ.
That cruiserweight quarter arm drag. Showing us why Miano maybe deserves to be in the ring.
All I'm saying is, This man's ducking me.
100%. Maybe one day you'll get that match.
Maybe one day. Chris, I've already beat the other one.
Yeah, Chris left for 2 years.
Tell him to watch the hair!
Extremely boring wrestling, like I said earlier.
Five!
Evil backyard wrestling.
Evil.
They're very evil.
Keep talking about it, I'll drag your ass back to the black heart.
No, you won't.
Uh-oh. Hey.
I ain't scared of you.
Last time I got dragged to the ring was royalty.
Come on, Miata.
Yo, Miata, no, you know you're better.
Oh, was it Vengeance? It was Vengeance. Yeah, it was the Mandible Claw from... Our wonderful, wonderful.
That was different, JJ. That was a 7-on-2.
That was awful. It's all right, Steve-O and Luke Blaze had my back, but you know, not so much anymore. It's okay. It's okay.
Hey, I had your back too.
You did. I do appreciate that.
Side headlock by Chris Jones. It feels so weird to be calling a Chris Jones match in 2023.
All right, looking good here.
Wrestling takedown, yeah, and now Payne crashing the back of Miano Diaz.
Look at that!
Man.
That's how it's done.
One has to wonder how much of the Chris Jones moveset we're going to see today. One of the longest in XCW history. He's got a move for every situation.
You need the back of the head, man.
Good call from the audience.
Illegal, rap.
Just remember,
I'm pretty sure
I picked you.
EBW,
both these guys sizing each other up. XCW versus EBW.
Well, Miano Diaz might not be the biggest dog in the fight, but he's got XCW blood running through his veins. Look at this. Look at that. Such a dastardly move by Chris Jones. Low blow. Miano Diaz, while the ref was not able to see it.
I wish I could say I was surprised, but this is par for the course for EBW.
I agree with Patrick on that one. 100%.
Patrick, oh.
Oh my god! That was like a shotgun going off. Jesus, he's lighting Miano Diaz up with these chops. Plate of chops being served here in Shelbyville tonight. My god!
Three in a row. Oh man.
Miano's chest is going to be caved in.
Yes,
and now, the scoop slam.
Get up, Miano!
Plants it like a tree. EBW and Patrick doing a good job. Oh, he looks at Patrick.
He's going to do the ball and left drop. Just like Patrick. Does. That's Patrick O'Reilly's move.
Oh,
cover,
man.
Two, and Miano able to get his shoulder up. Chris Jones is like a lion playing with his food at this point.
Yes, sir. It used to be Chris Jones' move, and I guess you could say he took it back, so to speak.
Yeah.
Oh, and here's EBW. Here we go.
Come on now.
Hayden Vex has the referee distracted on the apron. Here comes Brady Branson. Here comes Patrick O'Reilly here to... No, Patrick O'Reilly in the way. Not going to have to let that happen. Double axe handle to Miano Diaz on the outside.
Patrick O'Reilly trying to stay in the way here. Kudos to him for staying out of
the
action.
Come on, guys, I need it in the ring.
Come on, get up. Festus trying to keep things in order here.
Chris Jones is not going to listen to Festus. Remember what he said earlier. He doesn't follow our rules.
Unfortunately, that got him kicked out of the arena, out of the contest.
Oh, my God. He's going to cave his chest in.
Absolutely brutal.
He's not going to have any pecs left, no. No, you're not going to do this. So come on. No. Oh, my God.
On the apron. Oh, my.
For the love of God.
EBW really has no bottom limit. No depravity.
Yeah. Bottom feeder is too nice of a word for these guys.
Literally nothing is.
Jesus Christ.
Oh, my Lord. Nothing is under EBW. They will take whatever they have to do. And they proved it today.
There would be no shame in Miano Diaz staying down for a three count. I would not blame him after the odds are not in his favor anyway with these three yahoos at ringside.
Well, you know what's going to happen if he beats Chris Jones anyway.
Yeah,
it's just going to be a beatdown.
I didn't stutter.
Miano and Patrick would have to be on their A game.
Chris
again.
Jones paintbrushing him again like a dick. Look at this. Abdominal stretch being applied to Miano Diaz after all that. Look at the red marks on Miano Diaz's chest from the chops that he's taken at the hands of Chris Jones. And look at this blatant cheating by EBW. Hayden Vex has double by EBW.
Ref Festus was locked in, and you hate to see it. You hate to see it because you know that had to really, really hurt.
This is such horse crap. Look at this.
Oh, there we go. That's what I'm talking about.
Thank God for Festus. Festus asserting his authority as he should. I'm so sick to death of these fools.
Unfortunately, I think they're going to be here for a long time.
I cannot believe we got to put up with this crap. Quite a tote to get Chris Jones back in the ring. I don't want it, JJ. If this is what it took, he was better off being retired. Cover with a hand on the ropes. Not that it matters to Chris Jones.
Let's go, Miano. Show him what you got, Miano. Get up.
Again, as he said at the top of the show, he doesn't follow our rules. Doesn't seem to be any rules for him. That was a Rough Rider. Yes, you are correct.
Oh, man.
And that was
Chris Jones pulling it out.
And Chris Jones is in control here. Another Philly break. My God. How much more does Fiano Diaz have to suffer? This is absolutely deplorable.
Chris Jones really hasn't even attempted to pin him at all.
He's a lion playing with his food. It's ridiculous.
He is just going to take his time and inflict all the punishment he can. I think this is sort of a lesson to XCW. You know, this is what's going to happen to you.
What lesson are we learning here? The EBW are jerks?
Yeah, don't mess with the EBW.
My God.
Christ almighty, Chris Jones.
What happened there?
Penis! Get off Miano!
I think Miano reversed him.
Come on!
I didn't even catch that. Miano reversed him and got momentum on his side. Chris Jones is now in trouble for the first time in this match. Come on, Miano! You can do this!
Almost, but unfortunately.
Brady and Hayden are almost beside themselves out here watching this.
Yeah, and if Miano wins,
it's going to be hell to pay for Miano. That's for damn sure.
Yeah.
Here we go. Nope, head scissors.
That was insane.
Oh my God, I thought that was it.
Christ almighty.
I got to get a replay on that, JJ.
What do you even call that?
That was so close. It was a head scissors into a DDT.
I'll let you. That's some word soup there.
Spiked Chris Jones right on his head. He's lost his bandana. He never looked good in it anyway, to be honest.
Okay, who wrong about that?
Oh my God. Is he going for the CKO? I thought he was.
Going for the Illuminati.
Illuminati, yes. But no, unable to get it off. And Miano Diaz is fighting back. Come on, Miano. I know I'm supposed to be unbiased commentator, but I can't help but... Oh!
Wait a damn minute!
Oh my God! I can't believe how close Miano just came to winning the EBW title.
XCW!
Come on, Miano! Put this fool to rest!
It would be worth the beatdown at the end of the match.
Make him regret coming out of retirement. He should have stayed retired.
Miano looks like he's about to put this away.
The Montezuma's curse! Here he goes! He's got it!
Oh no! Chris! So heartbreaking.
Can he do it? Chris is rolling out. Oh my God, come on.
Chris tosses it right off and gets a break.
Damn
it. He's...
Get him back in the fucking ring!
On a count of 10, and he's in enemy territory. Oh, he drags him back in the ring.
Dragging him back.
Chris Jones is doing whatever he can.
Chris Jones trying to avoid a pinfall. Elbow drop. He's gonna do it again. Going to the well. One more time. Another Montezuma's curse might be happening here. He took off the elbow pad. This will be bare elbow this time. Here it comes. Oh no, the CKO! The Illuminati! He caught him in midair!
The JKO!
Oh my God!
What the?
Leon, get off!
How did he even pull that off? The margin for error. The window of opportunity Chris Jones had to hit that JKO.
I know, I'll get him. Oh, no, super kick, my God.
Oh.
Chris Jones.
I hate to admit it, but Chris Jones still got it.
Yeah, Chris Jones had help though.
True.
He didn't do it alone. He had help. He had Hayden Vex and Brady Branson.
Yeah, but you know, not to understand his achievements, he also had a JKO and almost Illuminati, a Rough Rider, the Philly Breaker. He was pulling out all the stops.
It is heartbreaking just how close Miano Diaz came to unseating Chris Jones, and now
it is, and unfortunately, Miano.
Miano and Patrick O'Reilly.
They're in territory right now, boys.
In the ring. What? Whoa.
Come on.
Patrick and Miano.
Patrick wanting it. Patrick wanting it.
What?
Wait.
Miano. Wait a damn minute. Miano.
No. No. You can't be serious. No.
It was all a ruse.
No.
No. What did we just witness?
No!
Miano was eating W the whole time!
Are you kidding me?
I guess he never forgave Patrick for the hardcore title. Oh, man.
Don't listen to them. You only bought in. I don't want to hear you guys talk on the mic anymore. Shut up. To be quite frank, I just whipped your ass. But you showed me that half the people on the XCW roster have it. That you were held down, never given the right opportunity. And you took that ass whooping like a man. You've been in this bitch's shadow far too long. It's time for you to step up and ascend to your rightfully deserved spot. I don't need to prove myself to anybody any longer. Someone else deserves the opportunity to represent Elite Backyard Wrestling as its world heavyweight champion. I want you to do that. And now, your new EBW champion. Go ahead and put that baby on. Your new EBW champion. The Soft Miano Diaz. Ladies and gentlemen, that is all for XCW High Stakes. Join us when we come back next show and save yourself and kick more ass.